Can I stay under you fight?
Where we been? Here we are. 2 weeks. We haven't been here, but we're here live.
Tonight, it's good to see the WZR Army back in the house. I forgot, EC fucking W, the old school, the old school shirt. I forgot to, change the shirt.
It's topical though, because my favorite series on the WWE Network is the Monday Night War. And last night's or today's episode, I think it just came out today, and I just watched it before we started. Just watched it. Was the ECW chapter.
ECW, baby.
How they influenced the war. Yeah. So that's why you wore the shirt.
Well, you know what? This is the only wrestling shirt that I own. I don't have any Cena shirts. I don't have any of that crap.
Is it the only one you've ever bought?
It's the only...
Even as a kid?
I'm sure when I was a kid, I had pro wrestling shirts.
I had the some of the Stone Cold ones. I think I had an NWO shirt.
I may wear a Steve Austin t-shirt if he's slamming beers or something like that. You know what I mean?
I had the one
The Raise Hell?
I didn't have the classic Austin 316. I had like a real complicated one. It was like a... not just a skull, a full skeleton giving you the finger and holding a beer or something.
See, that's not bad. That's not a bad t-shirt. I like this one, too, the EC fucking W.
I got pictures of me and, you know, Steve and my brother.
Yep.
In Ocean City, Maryland, getting drunk as shit, and I'm wearing it, and I'm, you know, drinking, holding a beer in the picture. And at the time, I thought I was like a fucking grown-ass man. If you look back on it, I look like a little baby.
Little kid.
And I'm drunk as fuck.
But what are you? Are you 29?
I'm 30.
I just turned 30
in July. 30. Yeah.
You don't look 30. You've got
even
a baby. No. You've got baby face. You've got a baby face. It's a good thing. I'm not taking a shot at you. It's a good thing to look younger.
Too.
Well,
that'll put some years on.
I've always had chub on my face, man. But you look a lot younger than 30 years old, which is a good thing. You never want to look older than
what
you are.
It's a good thing unless you want to go buy beer in a state that, like, for the longest time, I had an expired ID.
And they, Yeah.
My age is still the same, whether the ID's expired or current.
I know.
We can't. It's expired.
Can't do it. It's expired.
Even like cigarettes. They'll be like, oh, we can't. And at the time, I'd be like, let's just say 28 years. I'd be like, I'm fucking 28 years old. Right. I can't buy a pack of cigarettes. I'm 10
years
older.
And it's got your photo and your age on the thing.
Name,
so
photo,
what is the
age
problem?
Right there. Oh, well, it was expired. All right, I'm still the same age, though. It didn't change.
No, it's ridiculous.
Oh, legally, we can't. Oh, get it back. Fuck off.
I'll go to the next store. I'll give my business to somebody else.
Frick.
But, so here's the deal, man. We haven't been here for the past 2 weeks. First and foremost, we want to apologize to the people for that. 2 weeks ago, your computer had major issues.
Yes.
I came in here.
That one right there.
I looked at it for hours and hours and hours. I could not fix it. So finally, I said to you, you know what? I know it's a pain in the ass. Or you even came to me and said, you know what? Nobody's using your laptop.
Well, you had suggested fucking every time that something would happen with that. You'd say, dude, won't you just use the other one?
Use the laptop.
I'm like, dude,
use my laptop.
None of my programs are on it. None of my passwords are on it. Well, you got this thumb drive.
Right.
And it turns out all the programs are on this computer. Like, I didn't.
Right.
It has everything, and it's fucking.
Not only that,
much. I bought this at a pawn shop for $100.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because me and my sister got into a fight in my apartment. I pushed her, and she, when she went back, her foot stepped on it and, like, broke it, you know, instead of closing it this way, her foot
went the opposite way.
It was almost the opposite way. So it was crushed. And this one right here, the guy said, somebody pointed, there's viruses all over it from kitty porn. So I had a buddy fix it once when I was living in the hotel in Tampa.
Make it known that you bought it from a pawn shop and it came with the kitty porn on it.
No, there was no
download.
There was no kitty porn on it, but there was viruses on it. And the viruses stemmed from kitty porn.
Oh, okay.
And then, like, I guess it was somehow clear in the path. Like, you know how there's a path?
Okay.
Like, when you're running a scan, it'll say C/.
Yeah.
And it was like, it was obvious names of, like, kid porn.
Right.
Sucking dick, like, .avi, or you know what I mean? Like, stuff like that.
Sometimes you go to websites and they automatically download onto your computer without you knowing.
Right. Whoever pawned it to them must have been a freak, but I had a friend fix it, and he said, man, what are you into? I said, no. I said, I bought that from a pawn shop. And of course, you go, sure you did.
Yeah.
Fuckers, but.
But
long story short, that's a hunk of shit from day one. This was a brand new computer you got as a gift.
Right.
From who was it?
Gary. Yeah.
WrestlingInc.com guy. Yeah.
Right. Right.
Not to give him a plug or anything.
Yeah. Anyway, don't. But so I got it for as a gift. Yeah. And
it's a nice fucking computer.
It's basically been sitting here for years, and I haven't used it because I'm always working on my personal setup computer.
Yeah.
So I said to you, use it, man. Turns out it had most of the programs that you needed, and then anything else you needed, you just kind of brought it over. So,
yeah, thumb drive.
We weren't able to do it 2 weeks ago. We weren't able to do WZR TV. Then we come to last week. We had everything set up. Everything was ready to go, and we ran into the wireless router that we had set up. We didn't have internet for last Tuesday night. So I said to the people, let's do it on Thursday, right? I'm sitting there working on Thursday. Everything's good to go, working. All of a sudden, my Facebook page starts blowing up Thursday night at about 8 o'clock, WZR TV. I said, yo,
we just forgot.
I completely forgot.
So we get into routines. So, like, we both got...
It's always Tuesday night.
We both got a little touch of OCD.
Right.
You know, so we go through your routines every day, and Thursday, the show's not part of the routine, so it doesn't really cross your mind.
Right.
Unless you're reminded, which, by the time you saw the reminders, it was too late. We were busy and shit.
So Thursday night comes around, and they're all blowing it up. I said, I am so sorry. I completely forgot. I said, you know what?
It's cheap beer. Somebody asked in the
chat. It's the Milwaukee's Beast.
Yeah, what did they say? What kind of beer
Milwaukee's
is that?
Best.
It's the cheapest kind that you can buy, so...
So, I go into the chat room, and of course, Thursday night, the chat room is filled with people. Everybody's in there. And I said, all right, we need to make this up to you tomorrow night, okay? It's Night of Champions weekend. We got to do something Friday. Had every intention of coming on here on Friday at about 6 o'clock at night, fed the dogs, Reggie went to go get Daisy's food, and Daisy wound up snapping and biting him on the neck. Had to take Reggie into the emergency
room. Which
sucks,
because Reggie's fucking falling apart as it is.
Reggie's
getting
old.
Getting
up there.
What the hell do they call it?
Lyme disease.
Some of his ear mites or something?
Oh, the ear mites too.
He's got all kinds of problems. He just looks hard, like big chunks of shit out of his back and his chest. And then his bite was no fucking
Got medicine for him. Reggie's going to be okay. There's never been a problem with Daisy and Reggie like that before. So we weren't able... Don't fuck with the food. But, we weren't able to be here on Friday, and then here we are.
Right. Here we are.
So, we're back, and we're ready.
Here we are. Yeah.
A lot of stuff that we need to talk about over the last couple of weeks. 2 weeks worth of stuff. First of all, let's go back to last Monday night's Raw real quick.
Yeah,
you know what? Let's get the plugs out of the way. I want to talk about the main event of last Monday's Raw, Mark Henry and Rusev.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
All right, let me get the plugs out of the way, and then we're going to get right into it tonight. Talk a little bit about NFL. We'll do that all at the top here. Okay. We'll skim down, run down Monday Night Raw from last night, Night of Champions from Sunday night. Official website of WZR TV Tuesdays, WZRonline.com. We are on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Go to Facebook.com/WZR Army. Go to YouTube.com/WZR Archive. WZRonline.com. Top navigation bar. Drop down menu. It's got all the links to Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube right there. WZRonline.com. The official home of WZR TV Tuesdays.
That's the
key. Talk real quick.
This was the mouse.
Let's talk real quick about the NFL. Fantasy football, two different leagues.
I want
I'm in the WZR league. I'm in Dan's league.
Oh, that's right. You're 0-3 in
Dan's
both,
league,
right?
I'm 0-3. Yeah. WZR league, I'm 0-3. The problem I'm having is my backup team is doing better than the team that I'm starting.
You're
so
starting
I need
the wrong people. Yeah.
I need to take the players from my backup team and start them. Otherwise, I'd be killing people. I would be destroying people. You beat me in the WZR league.
Yeah, but that's my
only
win in the league. I'm 1-2 in both leagues.
Yeah?
So I'm not doing any better.
1-2 in both?
Both leagues.
Both leagues?
Yeah.
All right.
I beat you in the other league first week.
I know.
So the two times we've played, fucking gave you the pip smack.
I know.
But thanks to you, I have a win in both leagues. Otherwise, I'd be... winless as hell. You're the only guy I've beaten in either league.
I am 0-3 in both leagues, but the backup team is killing it, man. My Buffalo Bills looking good to start off the weekend. We had a tough game against San Diego this past week. We got beat up pretty good. Our offense didn't look good, but
two and one, right? The Bills
2-1.
Lions 2-1.
All right,
yeah.
No doubt.
So. Yeah.
Hey, and then one thing, we're gonna talk Night of Champions. I said to Boone, I said, dude, we weren't able to do a show, a pre-Night of Champions show.
Yeah.
Normally what we do is we do predictions, right? I sat down with you, Sunday afternoon.
Right before the
pay-per-view, yeah. Right before the event.
I'm sitting there getting everything, and you're like, dude, just come on. Give me your answers.
And Boone and I did predictions for Night of Champions. So, we're going to run it down.
I don't really want to do that.
We're going to run down the show. We're going to do predictions. John Cena. John Cena wins.
Not even that one.
I'm
pretty sure, spoiler alert, I think you win in general.
Oh, yeah?
I think so.
Well, I don't know how it comes out. But saying for weeks, John Cena's going to win, but...
You said for weeks he's taking the title.
But I did say...
But I'm like, oh, he's technically going to win on a DQ, and Lesnar's still going to be champion. Your
whole
thing.
Why do you have to spoil my party?
Because your party's bullshit.
John Cena wins, I said it.
Your argument was that Cena's taking the title. They can't have Lesnar not have the title on house shows, not on TV. They're still not going to have the title on house shows. They're still not going to have the title on TV. Mm. Nothing changes. I win. But because Cena wins, technically neither one of us can brag. We're both like, eh. It depends on if the glass is half full or half empty. We were both right, or we were both wrong.
You got me. You know what?
Neither one of us was right.
Yeah, John Cena wound up coming out on top, but our whole debate, week after week, was I had said exactly what you just said. There's no way that Brock Lesnar's not going to work house shows and Cena's not going to have the... Somebody's got to have the title defended on those house shows, and it didn't happen. So I'm actually going to give it to you, despite the fact
that John Cena won.
But anyways, alright. So here we go. Live chat room on and in progress right now, WZRonline.com. What do you got, muscles? You got big muscles?
No.
WZRonline.com/chat. Get in there, lots and lots of people in there, as always, tonight. Traffic on the websites.
It's bad today.
Not good,
not
man.
So great to chat, too. No. I was joking with you
take
before
2 weeks
show.
Off and
you take 2 weeks
happens.
Off, everybody bitches, where are you? Here we are, and nobody shows up.
No, not shows nobody, up. But
not as many as
it's
usual.
Traffic on the websites is not
I think
good.
It'd be good coming out of a pay-per-view.
You know, I was looking at my advertising rates. I was looking at the traffic. I don't want to be a Debbie Downer here, but it's not good for the month of September.
Debbie Downer. I've heard of that.
Yeah.
I haven't heard in a while, but
all right.
I remember the Saturday Night Live character, Debbie Downer.
Ah, new season.
She would say some
new
up
season.
Shit, and then they would zoom in on her. And she'd go,
yeah, you know. Yeah. New season. SNL starts this Saturday night.
I heard. See, I didn't know that, but I heard. Just, I keep up with pop culture. I don't go to TMZ like you and shit. The only way I know about anything is Facebook trends.
Yeah.
Because I'm on Facebook all the time to communicate with my boss and friends and shit like that.
Right.
And anything that's trending is usually like topical, either world event stuff, like politics, you know, that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. Some guy shooting up something, whatever. Or celebrity stuff.
That story in Pennsylvania.
And I was going to say about Saturday Night Live. I saw that Daryl Hammond is going to be the new announcer.
Yeah.
For the show.
Right.
I saw that.
And you know what else? Keenan.
Keenan's
leaving.
Yeah.
Is leaving the show. But
I don't watch it.
I am really intrigued by that story in Pennsylvania about the guy that's been hiding out in the woods. I know you don't know much about the story, but
nothing.
A guy shot two cops and has been hiding in the woods in Pennsylvania. Okay. They can't find him. They've got 400 law enforcement officers looking for this guy, and they can't get him. Nobody knows where he is, but they think he's out in the woods somewhere. Before we get into Night of Champions of Monday Night Raw, two sad pieces of news that we need to talk about, both pro wrestling related. Eric the Actor passed away, a big fan of pro wrestling, both WWE and TNA. Three deaths, to be honest with you. Michael Moody, Paul Bearer's son, passed away as well. But
which is weird. I got a friend named Michael Moody.
I mean, we'll go through him. Eric the Actor, huge fan of TNA, had done some stuff with TNA in the past.
Worked with TNA. He's been at like WWE. I know he's at a John Cena film premiere once. They talked about that on the show. He loves wrestling. He lived for wrestling in the Howard Stern show. And, that one was sad, man. I've talked to that guy on Twitter before, recently.
Yeah.
A couple months ago.
Oh,
I
is that the one you did talk
to? Yeah, we talked back and forth on Twitter a couple times. So it was kind of weird. Not for that reason, but just because I've listened. You know me, I listen to Stern every single day.
Every day.
Today he had Lenny Kravitz and Sarah Silverman on. I listen every single
day. Right.
And yesterday at Kimmel on. Jimmy Kimmel's a big fan. He was talking about it and stuff. But just, I hear him every day, and then to know that I'm never going to hear him call in.
Now,
weird.
He used to call up and just rant and rave about pro wrestling,
he was a mean
right?
little prick. Now, not so much about pro wrestling. Like, he would, if there were wrestlers on, he would talk about, but normally they would just ignore him.
There's a big hashtag on Twitter going around, something about, like, something by.
Natalie Maines tried to start that. I don't know what it is, but I know what you're talking
something
about.
Something by?
They talked about it, yeah.
Okay, bye or something like that?
Bye for now?
Bye for now?
Yeah, that's his catchphrase when he would hang up.
Oh, he would say
Eric,
bye
for
now.
All right, Eric, you gotta go. And he went, okay, bye for
okay.
now.
Okay, okay, that's yeah. what it is. All right. A second one is Michael Moody, the son of Paul Bearer, who I spoke with when Paul Bearer had passed
that's
away.
Right.
Paul had two sons, Daniel and Michael.
Yeah.
And Michael passed away. We're waiting for the autopsy results to come back on that. Not sure what the deal was there.
Well, what did you think of WWE?
That's where I'm going. No, go ahead. I mean,
well, what did you think about WWE?
Yeah,
acknowledging Eric the Actor Lynch, Eric the Midget.
Right.
They, I mean, they stopped
Eric
the show.
The actor, not
yeah.
Midget.
Well, Eric
well,
the Midget
yeah,
was what
was
they called.
Okay. Okay.
No, that was his name, Eric the Midget. And Eric, I'm not a midget. Call me Eric the Actor.
All right.
You know who?
So last night on Raw,
they stopped
yeah.
the show. They go straight, just like us, straight up to the announcers, and you get the shot right on the announcers, and very sad news. You know, blah blah blah. Eric the Actor. And then they don't mention Michael Moody at all on the show. They did on the website, you said, right? But
that
not during the show, and I thought that was really strange.
You know, they mentioned Eric the Actor live on Raw, and they didn't mention him on .com.
No.
And then
yeah.
for Michael Moody, they mentioned him on .com, but not on Raw.
Yeah.
So it was kind of...
TNA did a lot of internet stuff with Eric the Actor. Like, all of them tweeted
oh,
about
yeah.
it.
Dick yeah.
Carter and all
right,
the pictures
right.
and everything. Because he's worked with TNA in the past.
He's been there. He's, like he's been
he
at shows.
He used to be like a guest host on their internet show. What the fuck is it called? What the fuck is that show called?
TNA show?
What the hell is that right. show called? Spin Cycle.
Spin Cycle. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
He co-hosted that or something. Like,
yeah.
he worked with them, you know?
Yeah, but it was...
And they,
it
had,
was
they had an angle with him and Bobby Roode. Remember Bobby
yep,
Roode?
Bobby
Roode. With promos on him and
right,
shit. Yeah.
Right, right. But it was interesting that WWE kind of gave the snub to Michael Moody. I mean, I guess they mentioned it on WWE.com, but it was just weird. It seemed kind of out of place.
And you can make the argument that, oh, he's never, other than the Hall of Fame, to induct his father after he died. Well, he's never been a WWE personality, this and that, but neither was Eric the Actor.
Right,
so if
right.
you're going to go out of your way to acknowledge this one, why not that one? And then later
right.
in the show, cause somebody, when we posted, we both made posts about it on Facebook right after they did it. Like, why then? Why him and not Michael
right.
Moody?
Right,
and everybody was like, well, maybe they'll save it for hour two, and then I think it was John Morgan, at least on my thread, replied and said, do you really think they're going to... All right, wrestling, excitement. Oh, we got some sad news. All right, let's
yeah,
get over that. Wrestling,
yeah.
excitement.
That's a good point.
And back to sad news. But they did
right.
do that because later in the show, about an hour later, they shot back to the announce team and they did the Conor's Cure, and it was the sad voices.
The Conor McGregor
yeah.
thing,
no,
right?
Not Conor
right.
McGregor, that's a fighter.
That's the fighter.
Conor,
it's
I don't know.
Similar.
It's like, I don't know how to say
the
it.
The Crusher. They
yeah.
call him Conor the Crusher.
I just say
yeah,
Conor,
yeah.
Conor's Cure is the charity. But yeah, they did it again, so it wasn't like, oh, we didn't want to do them all at once, or, you know, or save it for later.
I thought maybe they were going to do something during the Kane matches that made sense, Paul Bearer, Kane,
yeah,
Undertaker, that whole
I
thing,
guess.
But nothing there. I mean, there was nothing last night for Michael Moody. And then the third passing in the last 2 weeks is Sean O'Hare.
Oh, that's right. Jesus. That one,
yeah.
was, that one was controversial.
That was, I mean, here's the deal.
Himself.
We put up, after the news broke of the death, we put up an exclusive article on the website. I talked to somebody that had connections
You've
to...
You've talked to Sean O'Hare before in
Sean.
The past.
Right, right.
When he, I think it was doing the kickboxing or something.
It was way back.
Oh, yeah,
a
TV
day.
Show or something.
Way
something.
Back.
Yeah,
yeah. yeah. Well, Palumbo had the TV show.
Oh, that was it, the biker show?
I talked to,
okay,
I talked to Palumbo about O'Hare.
They were tag partners.
Tag team partners
yeah,
back in the day.
So that, I got it confused. Okay.
I talked to Palumbo about O'Hare, and we put up the exclusive story on the website that O'Hare, you know, had basically cut off all communications with a lot of his friends, wouldn't answer their phone calls, this, that, and the other thing, had fallen into a state
yeah.
of deep depression, turned to alcohol and drugs. WWE offered him rehab numerous times, went to rehab 6 times over the
Did
past
he?
2 or 3 years, I believe. WWE paid for him 2 or 3 times out of, you know, during the last couple of years.
I just puked in my mouth a little bit and had to swallow that.
He did take WWE up on their rehab offer several times. they tried to recently, within the last couple of months, tried to get him once again into a rehab. He did not, this time, respond to their phone calls.
But they tried to get him again. How did they know that he was still having a problem?
They knew that he had problems. And
mutual
I,
friends? My, but my, if Flair's not talking to anybody, well, how would they know that he needs help?
My feeling, well, that's the thing, is he wasn't answering WWE's phone calls. He wasn't answering phone calls.
But my question
friends,
is, how would WWE know to call him if nobody's in communication
with him? My guess
them
would be that WWE, people that have been sent to rehab on WWE's dime, I would guess that WWE would call up to check up on them to say, hey, how are you doing? Are you staying clean? Are you staying sober? And when they went to do that, wasn't answering phone calls. Same thing with friends. I know that he was living with his parents in his final months, didn't have any money whatsoever, was completely broke, was staying with his mother and father. And, you know, a guy that is successful, made it to WWE.
The guy, WWE, WCW, he fought in Pride Bushido, I believe. I know he fought in K-1.
He was making money back in the day.
I'm just saying, he's done MMA, he's done wrestling, he's done movies, I think he did some, like, little shit movie work and stuff that, you know, so he's been here and there, made money.
He made some good money back in the day, and the fact that he had fallen to completely broke, to the point where he was living at home with his parents.
Well, that's if you're a drug addict, you know, that's where your money's going.
Well, all the money's going to drugs and alcohol.
That's what I'm saying. Even if he made money, if he's a drug addict, he didn't make that much money. He wasn't a millionaire, you know.
No,
it wasn't like many times over, a multi-millionaire.
And that money goes quick.
Or like the chick in Jeopardy said, a double millionaire.
Double millionaire.
That's it. He's not a multi-millionaire. Or like the Jeopardy chick, double millionaire.
But, just a really sad story. You know, the police wound up. His father was the one that found him in his bedroom.
Horrifying.
Father walked into the bedroom and saw that he had committed suicide by hanging, hung himself on a bedpost.
Yeah, could you imagine? Sheet, so. I mean, I don't have kids, neither do you, but could you imagine if you did, like I don't want to say it, like, say one of your nephews or niece, and you find them. You're not supposed to bury your kids or your nephews and nieces. They're supposed
to
bury you.
Right.
Not only did he have to bury them, but he had to fucking see them laying there dead. You know, that whole scene, that's fucking terrifying.
It's traumatizing.
No shit. I mean, that's going to fuck your head up. I mean, you remember
my father, that poor Graham, you know.
Remember Eddie Graham, the legendary Florida promoter.
Right.
Famous grandbrothers that Vince idolized as a kid and shit. He was the father of Mike Graham. Eddie Graham killed himself.
Mm-hmm.
And then Mike Graham killed himself later in life, you know, so it's
so sad, man.
Probably
so
hit the fucking sad image, and, you know, you get depressed. And,
you know, it was, he had fallen on really tough times. And, you know, Palumbo said that he was the nicest, most giving, caring guy, where if you needed something and he had it to give to you, he'd give it to you, man. So
see, that's what everybody says when someone dies, they're the nicest this and that. I don't know if he was or wasn't.
I don't know either.
You know, but bottom line is, the guy took his own life. That's kind of a fucking, like, look at it this way. Kind of like, what an asshole to do that to your family and friend, you know, like.
I haven't, kind of selfish. I mean, listen, yes, there's times where I get depressed and you know, you can't, I don't want to go out and say that, because if you've never struggled with depression, or if
addiction,
you've never struggled with addiction, you don't know what it's like. And people that fall into deep depression that aren't on medication,
addiction and depression feed each other.
Correct.
If you're depressed and addicted, they feed each other. The more depressed you are, the more you become addicted. The more addicted you are, the more depressed you become. It's like a fucking vicious cycle.
From years ago, I know how addiction works, and you do as well.
Yes, I do.
And there are people that, you know, you'll see them comment on stories, whether it be on Facebook or CNN, and they say, well, why would you ever take a drug in the first place? You brought it upon yourself. This, that, and the
that's
other thing.
Fucking ignorant.
It's very ignorant. Yeah. So, for us to come out here and say, you know, he took his own life, it's kind of a dickhead thing. I don't know how severe depression like that, like what he had.
There's no excuse.
I don't know how that works, but there's no excuse.
Did he have kids?
You can't say there's no excuse with it.
There is no excuse for it.
Well, there's no excuse for addiction either, is what you're saying.
You can't help, but you don't kill yourself. I can't do it.
I can't say that. I don't know. I'm not that depressed where I've fallen into a state where severe depression. I thought about killing myself,
but you can't do it. You can't do it, man.
I don't know, man. I think people become so depressed, severe depression, which I've never experienced. Yeah. So I can't talk about it.
I can relate to it completely.
And I'm not saying state like he was, though.
Okay, but either way, I'm just saying they say it's the coward's way out. I think that's harsh, but it's a bad thing. You know,
yeah, it's
a bad thing to do, to kill yourself on purpose like that.
If you
take a bunch of pills to try and kill the pain and accidentally, that's one thing. But to purposely take yourself, that's first of all, it's blasphemy. That's you know, you're not religious, but you don't take your own life. That's God decides when, you know.
Listen to Eric the actor, you know, Paul Bearer.
Rest in peace to all of them,
Sean and to their families. Sean O'Hara, absolutely. To all of their families, you know. I mean, they've got family members. They've got families, nephews, kids, things like that.
That are all
struggling right now over the death of their loved ones.
Well,
let's
get past that and have some fun.
Yeah, man. Let's get on. One other thing I want to talk about, The Undertaker's health. Fred Durst came out at a Limp Bizkit
contest. Can I ask you this, though?
Yes.
I guess you should say it first. I was going to say, do we know for sure that Fred Durst said it? Is there a video of him saying
Fred
it?
Fred Durst came out at a recent concert, was up on stage. We have a quote. Numerous people picked it up. I mean, he was on stage. He basically said that, hey, I want to give it up to The Undertaker, who is not in good health.
Yeah, keep him in your prayers.
Keep him in your prayers.
Which makes it sound...
He's not doing good. He's not doing well.
Sounds drastic.
Michelle McCool.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Well, if you recall, not too long ago, a couple weeks ago, there was a picture of The Undertaker with some kids. He was good enough to be out and about.
That's what I said.
I mean? So how could he be gravely ill? Like, but, you know, you never know. You know, you could fall gravely ill. Like, the actor is a perfect example.
Absolutely.
I mean, he dealt with physical stuff his whole life because of his condition, but the guy that takes care of him, his caretaker on Stern Show.
Yeah, he said one day, right?
He said he was fine, just out of the blue. He started having stomach pains, and bam, next day he was dead.
Next day.
That quick. I mean, he had called into the Stern Show the previous show.
Recently,
before the weekend.
Yeah.
Recently, he calls in every day, first of all.
Oh, does he?
They don't put him on every day, but I'd say at least 2-3 times a week, and he only does 3 shows a week now.
Right.
Stern, because of his schedule.
Stern only does 3?
Monday, Tuesday,
really?
Wednesday, that's it.
I didn't know that.
That's it.
Really?
Is it because
of the TV show?
Kind of, it's that, and just because he's rich as fuck and
doesn't need it. Right. Well, I didn't know that.
Sucks, man.
But, so one day you fall out like that.
Bam, just like
right.
that, yeah.
But The Undertaker, Fred Durst came out, Limp Bizkit, they were on stage and basically said, you know, like you said, keep him in your thoughts and prayers, he's not in good shape.
Which doesn't sound good.
And I had put up in the original post that we did, I said, you know, there were some photos that came out just a couple of weeks ago, like you said, that he looked good. He looked old as fuck. He looked old, but you know what I mean? But he looked good. And then Michelle McCool came out.
She looks good as fuck.
She looks good as fuck. Two nights ago and said, don't believe the rumors that are online about Taker's health.
See, that's okay. If we get into the Tammy Sitch story.
Tammy's not
Why
doing
does she
good.
Yell at people? Like we reported that she had a seizure because...
She ain't doing good.
But I'm just saying, like, why, like, she always does that when there's a rumor about her, if it's not true. Hey, you fucking morons, quit spreading rumors. Like, we heard something, we posted, like, there's pictures of you.
We hear something, there's photos.
Said there's pictures of you on conscience. Okay, we didn't jump the gun and say seizure. I don't think Hacksaw Jim Duggan came out and said seizure, but the report going around was that it was a seizure. All we did was say, hey, there's a report going around that states Tammy Sitch had a seizure.
I got two
out.
Different fan reports that said
that
Tammy was
Who
sitting
were there?
In a chair.
Yeah.
She was sitting in a chair. She fell out of the chair, went to the ground, and was violently shaking on the ground.
But my point
two
is...
Two different reports.
And that's true. She admitted that. She got dizzy and passed out. And there's pictures of her, so all that's true, but because of that one word seizure, hey, you fucking morons, quit spreading rumors, begin a lie.
The title of the news post said Sonny reportedly suffers a seizure.
Oh,
reportedly. There's a reason that
So you're
word.
Agreeing with me then. I'm
Absolutely.
Saying, like, why does she go out?
I agree
why does
with
she
you.
Flash out? Like,
she always does.
That's what I'm saying. And now there's an incorrect rumor. Like, you can't get them all right. And quite frankly, we were fucking 99% right on the story. The only thing that was wrong was a seizure, which we made sure to say allegedly, reportedly, etc.
Last time I spoke to her and I came on here and I told you guys, I said the last time I spoke with Tammy, she was slurring her words, she didn't sound good, I didn't want to accuse her of anything, but I said, I don't know that she is sober. Then this comes out, and not only that, but in the last couple of weeks, last month or two, there's been appearances where she's supposed to host a pay-per-view, WWE pay-per-view party, she's canceled out. She's supposed to have appeared at a couple of indie events. Canceled out. Nothing.
Last minute.
This comes out that all of a sudden she starts sweating, gets dizzy, goes to the ground. Last time I talked to her, she was slurring her words like you wouldn't believe.
Draw your own conclusions.
You draw your own conclusions to that. And then you see her Twitter rants that she put up where the spelling was ridiculous.
That doesn't mean
it was, I know, you never know how somebody's grammar is. Is that, draw your own conclusions on that, but not in good shape. Anyways, Night of Champions.
Night of Champions.
This past Sunday night. We got about a half an hour to get through Monday night. Oh, one last thing. Last Monday night's Raw.
Yes.
They main evented with Rusev and Henry. Mark Henry and Rusev.
Right? Yeah.
Right. They did the whole thing with the halftime. Did you see the Raw rating that came out for last night?
I saw the viewership. I didn't see the rating.
2.7.
Oh, damn.
Can I show
what was
this
last week? Yeah, go ahead. What was last week? 2.8, 2.9?
2.9.
2.9, so it wasn't that much down. But coming out of a pay-per-view,
right,
generally you're supposed to go up. And all week they had teased Next Generation this Monday night, Next Generation, Next Generation. And it didn't even hit me until after the show, you came in here and said, yo, what the hell happened to the Next Generation? I said, son of a bitch, I didn't think of that. And then as we were talking, it hit me, what the fuck was Wyatt at last night? And
there was Wyatt, there was no Heyman.
There was no, Roman Reigns, obviously, no Jericho, obviously, but, a lot of star power was down, and I still thought the show was good. I've seen all the feedback.
It's pretty good, man.
All the feedback, people think it sucked.
No, a lot of people on my Facebook page saying it was
pretty
good.
All the feedback I'm reading,
really?
It was a garbage show, this and that, throwaway show.
A lot of people on my Facebook page saying it was pretty good.
I had a couple, too, but
yeah.
I'm not talking about our fans.
Okay.
Other sites I've listened to radio shows and this and that, and they're trashing the shit out of the show.
Oh, I didn't think it was that bad.
I thought it was pretty good.
Yeah.
Especially considering what we just said, the lack of stars. No Brock Lesnar, Paul Heyman,
right.
Roman Reigns, Wyatt Family, Jericho. Hey, without all those people, and they still delivered a pretty good show, and I'd say large in part due to Dean Ambrose.
Dean Ambrose is...
That was his
shining
moment.
You know. I've been saying it for months now. You've been right there
absolutely,
with me, saying that Dean Ambrose is the next big thing. And,
I don't know if he's the next big thing, but he's got a future.
He's got a long-term future.
And
no
I will say, he has the... If they gave him the ball, he could be the next big thing.
I don't
think they'll give him the ball, though.
I think so.
So
let's see here. I didn't like the end of Raw with the Rollins. Was it Raw? Rollins cashing in? No, it was Night of Champions, right?
Yeah, well, he didn't cash in. Technically, he did.
Right.
But they've done that so many
fucking times. And then you got to wait for the bell to ring.
I don't like when they go officially announce it on the microphone. Ladies and gentlemen,
Let's get into it. So, Night of Champions, overall, top to bottom, pretty good show. There was some good wrestling on it.
Ask me again after the show.
Okay.
After
all
we run it
no
down.
Doubt.
I have a good memory.
They kicked it off. The pre-show was the Usos. The Peep Show was the pre-show with Christian. Wound up coming back.
It was weird, too. Randy Orton was doing comedy. He was up making jokes at their extent, mocking them and stuff. I thought that was weird for the Viper to be making jokes and shit,
Yeah, well, Chris Jericho and Christian went back and forth.
I thought that was funny. You didn't like it?
Jericho was kind of heelish.
No, they were both
They were joking, but
fucking
it was...
with each other, yeah.
I know. I don't know.
I was the reason our tag team, and we were I'm the reason we were good. I was the leader. You were my backup.
Did announce that. I mean, the last we heard.
How many times have you seen the word page spelt that way?
All the time.
That's not how you spell page. P-A-G-E, right? That's page.
No, Paige as a name
is... I've never even heard of the name of
that way.
But anyway,
Paige is like turning a page of a book.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. This is not Diva Paige. This is some ad for something else, but it's still spelled P-A-I-G-E.
Oh, okay, I see what you're saying. Yeah. No,
that's...
Yeah, that is...
But anyways,
We're looking at this
dumb fucking uninstalled show. I'm sorry.
But anyways, all right. So we had they kicked off the show with the Usos against Stardust and Goldust for the WWE Tag Team Titles. You and I, with our predictions.
I know, I picked them, right?
We both picked the Rhodes Brothers.
Dust Brothers.
Picked, yes, the Dust Brothers.
Yeah.
Rhodes Brothers, whatever.
You know that they're calling them Gold and Stardust now? That's their official, that's how you say it.
Gold and Stardust?
Gold and Stardust, yeah. Instead of Gold Dust and Stardust, it's Gold and Stardust.
What do you think of the gimmick? Just weirdos.
It's, you know, whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
Cody's trying to out-weird Gold Dust, too. You can tell that when you watch
him. Right. So we both expected a title change to take place here. I mean, they're doing a lot in recent weeks with the Rhodes Brothers, with the backstage promos and the segments. I thought this was a really good match to kick things off.
Great opener.
Every kind of match that Goldust has been in as of late, I'm telling you, man.
As of late, since this run. Since
he's killing it.
Yeah, he's great. Especially for his age and all that, you know.
He's killing it, man. I do like
the Usos. The Usos are amazing.
I think they've come a long way.
Really, really underrated. As far as, like, when you talk about the workhorses and the best, you talk about Seth Rollins, you talk about this guy, Daniel Bryan, you know, you talk about those people.
Right.
I think the Usos are in that category. They're that good.
I'm right there with you, man.
I haven't seen a bad Usos match.
And we haven't, I mean, the WWE Tag Team Division, I mean, we see them throw teams together here and there, right? Yeah. And then they split up, this, that. The Usos have been a long-term
tag team. Well, yeah, like you're saying, normally you take two individuals and make them a team. Those are a true through-and-through tag team.
I agree.
You know, like Harper and Rowan are kind of two individuals, but they've been a tag team the whole time.
Absolutely.
Like, name another tag team that's a full-on tag team. I can't think of one off the top of my head.
I mean, they were doing something with, I mean, this is the new breed, obviously, but like Ryback and Curtis Axel.
No, that's
like,
two individual stars that they put together. I'm saying, they start off as a tag team.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like, I can't think of any. Los Matadors, but, you know, what the fuck were they? But
there really hasn't been it. You're right. Absolutely. So a really good match to kick off the show. So we're both 1-1 here for our predictions.
All right.
We had Ziggler and, God, we had B. Ziggler and R. Ziggler backstage, right? Whatever, we can skip that.
Yeah.
Sheamus and Cesaro for the United States title. I picked Sheamus. Boone picked Cesaro.
Give me my logic, and I explained it to you. I made sure to give you a little explanation so that you can't deny it when we come on the air. I said they're either switching the U.S. title
or the IC title,
which they never did, by the way. But they saved it for Raw, and I've got an explanation for that. Because I knew they're not switching the world title. That's what I knew, so I based it off of that. I said, Tonight of Champions, the gimmick is every title's on the line. They have to do at least one or two title changes.
Right.
They ain't changing the world title. Lesnar's keeping it. So which titles are they going to change? Divas title, don't even matter if they change that. They got to change one of the male men's titles.
Mm-hmm.
So I picked the tag titles, and I said one or the other. U.S.
It's
got to
be one or the other. Right.
And the reason that they saved the IC title for Raw to get switched, because Ziggler won the IC title back on Raw, I think they knew they were lacking depth, talent-wise, going into Raw, with Reigns out and Jericho being done at Night Champions, no Bray Wyatt,
Lesnar,
no Brock,
Heyman,
those names not being there. They needed something to happen to make it a good, you know, we're going to change the title tonight. Let's save it for tomorrow night so that we have something for Raw, because we don't have a whole lot with all these names missing for the show. But that was my theory for why I picked Cesaro.
All right, no doubt.
I figured probably Cesaro would be in.
My feeling is, and we put it up on the website, that WWE officials, for some reason or another, have soured on Cesaro in recent months.
Have they soured on him, or they just not know how to handle
Maybe that's what it is.
I think it's more of that.
They don't know how to book him.
Both.
They don't know how to book him. But, you know?
The fucking guy, we were just talking about the Usos and how good they are. First of all, this match, and we haven't even mentioned this yet, this match was amazing.
Very hard.
You might say this might be hard. I'm trying to think of the rest of the card.
Hitting, man.
That was probably the best match on the entire show. What do you think of that?
I would agree with it. Yeah, it was hard hitting.
What match was better than that on that show?
We'll go through it, and then I'll point something out. Maybe I won't.
I don't think there was anything better than that on the show.
They beat the shit out of each other, too, man. Stiff. Yes. Hard-hitting stuff.
Exactly what you expect from those two.
Right.
Yeah.
Sheamus retained with a brogue kick there. So, that was that. We had, I don't want to skip anything big. Big Show backstage with Mark Henry. Big Show basically saying you got to represent the United States. You got me on that one.
Christ. All right. Florida Georgia Line.
Oh, Jesus, right? God, they were on commentary for the Ziggler and the Miz for the IC title. Here's the problem I have.
Ignored the entire...
Ziggler and Miz are in the ring having a great match, a really good match.
You read
and
my
yet,
play-by-play.
And yet...
Huh?
No.
Is your own opinion? Because I was going nuts writing on play-by-play. Like, these guys are busting their fucking ass, and they're not even...
They didn't mention it, right?
They're ignoring the shit out of it. They're just goofing around with this country band.
I agree. I mean... give it up to Florida Georgia Line. They're going on the Tribute to the Troops special with WWE.
And they're clearly fans. They were one of the Raw guest hosts.
Big fans.
They got physically involved, I believe, at the end. And one of them
during this match, Sandow came over. And Sandow, who was at ringside with The Miz, came over and started talking smack.
Mizdow.
Okay. started talking smack. And the two guys, the... Florida Georgia Line stood up and shoved him down.
Have you ever heard of the band Florida Georgia Line before they went to
WWE? We talked about it on here before where I said, does one of the guys live in Florida and the other in Georgia, and do they live near the border or something? I don't know. I remember bringing that up.
Because my point is,
I'm not a country fan, but I know that they are a big enough group in country music. That
reason for bringing that up is they introduced the biggest band in the world, kept reiterating it too, like they're the biggest band. I never fucking heard of them. How are they the biggest band in the world? Then again, I'm out of touch. I'm starting to become the old guy that doesn't know remember all those nude pictures leaked on the internet of all the celebrities?
Yeah.
You and my boss Shalik have both been thrown up, like, hey, this person's naked picture leaked. And
Kate Upton, who? Vanessa Hudgens.
Who? I don't know either one of them people.
You don't know Kate Upton?
No, but
Kate Upton?
Vanessa Hudgens. What? I've seen the name. I don't know what she's from, but I've seen that
Spring
name.
Spring Breakers with Selena Gomez and Ashley Tisdale. Spring Breakers?
Don't know. I know. Say those names again.
Ashley Tisdale.
I don't know that one.
Selena Gomez.
I've heard of that one.
Dating Justin Bieber.
She's a singer or something.
On and off, right?
Yeah, okay. So I know Selena Gomez, right. But I couldn't pick her. You put two people in front of me and said, which one's Selena Gomez?
Boy, you are out of touch, man.
I am.
You are really out of touch. You gotta go to TMZ more.
Yeah, I don't think
you
so.
You gotta go to TMZ more. All right, we had...
balls in these pants here. They won't allow it.
Selena Gomez is jack off material.
Well, I go to
so
a fucking
you pull your balls out and jack off. Right. Fucking Selena
go
Gomez.
Go to a celebrity news site or something. Not TMZ to jerk off. What the fuck?
TMZ puts up some bikini photos of fucking Selena Gomez and Kate Upton. You're gonna be out there.
Check it out.
We had Seth Rollins comes out.
Well,
Miz cuts promo.
What's our prediction? Miz retained, right? Or
Ziggler
retained.
Miz Ziggler wound up retaining.
Yeah.
Because I picked Miz.
Okay.
And you picked Ziggler.
Right, so we're even now, 2-2.
So we're all tied up right now. But the following night on Raw, I still got it back, right?
What?
No.
We're talking about Night of Champions predictions. Right now we're 2-2.
No, Miz won the title here.
No, he didn't. He won it on Raw.
No, Ziggler won it back on Raw.
Oh, he did. You're right.
I'm up.
Okay, yeah.
All right, so Miz won the title here, and then Ziggler got it back on Monday Night Raw.
Right.
So I win this one by picking
Miz.
All right,
so my explanation isn't going to make any fucking sense.
Well, that, you're going to take what I was just going to say is you should get it because... Ziggler got it back on Monday Night Raw.
No, my explanation for why I picked Cesaro, I said one of them switching, and the reason they didn't switch the IC title and saved it for Raw, they did switch the IC title, they just switched it back at Raw.
Yes.
So my explanation didn't make any fucking sense.
Right.
I was
my whole thing.
It made me sound stupid, and I didn't realize it.
My whole thing going into Night of Champions is I've seen what they've been doing with The Miz as of late, right? They're giving him a pretty solid push. Week after week, they're doing the whole Hollywood thing, this, that, and the other thing. So I said, you know what? They're not sold on Dolph Ziggler, so I think probably The Miz is going to win the title at Night of Champions. Now, going into Raw last night, I did not expect Ziggler to get the title back. I thought Miz was going to have a run for the title, and that was that. So,
I agree.
All right, so I'm up 2-1.
Yeah, you're up
2-1. All right, Seth Rollins comes out, cuts promo, basically makes fun of Roman Reigns. They brought up the real-life storyline. We got to talk about Roman Reigns, man. Into the weekend, arrived in Memphis on Saturday.
He had an emergency surgery. No, it was Nashville.
Okay, Nashville, right.
Memphis was Raw. Right. He had emergency surgery for an incarcerated hernia, I think is what it's called.
Yeah,
which is supposedly like real fucking dangerous.
Said he woke up Saturday morning, was in Nashville, Tennessee, ready for the pay-per-view, so was in town.
He was doing promotional work.
Promotional work, was in town for the pay-per-view, woke up in the morning, had real severe pains, wound up calling 911. They came, took him to the emergency room, and had to do emergency surgery.
Yes.
For a hernia.
An incarcerated hernia. Incarcerated. That's what they call it. Wait, is that it? Incarcerated hernia?
I believe so. I believe
Isn't
so.
Isn't it incarceration when you go to jail? What the fuck?
Maybe I said it wrong.
But
anyways, so they took him in. They did the surgery. Reigns put up some videos and some tweets and things of that nature.
Yeah, from his hospital bed.
Gave updates. WWE put an article up on WWE.com, said that he was going to be out 4 to 6 weeks. Now, on Raw last night and at Night of Champions, they were saying...
And the breaking up, you didn't mention that they, on the article, they said to tune into the WWE Network at 1 p.m. Eastern Time.
Okay.
We're going to break into the program and give you a big breaking update on Roman Reigns. They never did that until like fucking 3 p.m.
Oh, really? It took a while?
Because I've got the network now.
Right.
So I logged in to watch it, and it was like, of all things, it was a CM Punk documentary.
I think that's cool that they bring in, that they break in like CNN does or NBC.
They own the network. They can do whatever they want.
The thing will pop up. Dun 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 dun. You know what I mean?
And they're a big record breaking update or, you know.
I think that's cool that they're able to do that as long as they have somebody.
But yeah, to your point, the update, like they mentioned, several months was the key word.
So it seems like it may be longer than 4 to 6. I mean, 4 to 6 weeks is a month and a half.
Well, I heard that he might be. They were hoping he's back in time for Survivor Series. But no matter what, he'd be back in time for Royal Rumble, which makes sense because even if it's several months, look, it's September, you got the rest of September,
October,
November, December, January's Royal Rumble. That's still going to be 5 months
he'll be
ready
by the Royal Rumble.
So if they want to do like we've been talking about, Lesnar's this unbeatable monster all the way into WrestleMania, never loses the title, never loses a match, ends a streak, squashes Cena, beats Cena in a rematch, keeps the title for the whole year going into WrestleMania, and who finally stops him? Roman Reigns and his big star-making performance. He's
like
a made man in one night.
I like that.
They can still do that because he'll be back in time to win the Rumble, which guarantees him the title shot at WrestleMania against Lesnar. And, and there, you know, you're off and running.
There you go. That works.
So they can still do that even with this situation.
And I don't think they're going to derail his push, you know, with everything.
He'll be even bigger when he comes back.
He'll be even bigger because when he returns, he's going to get that massive pop.
Absence makes the heart grow fonder. That's
absolutely.
They say you go away for a long time.
Right.
You come back, and they love you even more because they haven't seen you in so long.
Right, exactly.
It's always happened. I remember when Triple H was out for when he tore his quad.
Right.
I remember that. Remember the YouTube, "It's a Beautiful Day."
Yeah.
They were doing a video pack. When he finally came back in MSG, I remember.
Oh, my God. They popped.
Holy shit,
huge,
man. And he was a fucking
huge.
A heel's heel when he left.
Right,
like
right,
the biggest heel in the company, probably. When he came back. Biggest face in the company.
Biggest baby
just
face.
Like that.
Just because he had been out for a full
year. Well,
that
and because the videos made him look very sympathetic or empathetic. It, like, people felt for him. Like, yeah, poor guy.
Right,
you know, that kind of thing.
So Rollins is out there. He's making fun of Roman Reigns. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
He issues an open challenge. Anybody on the roster, come out and face me right now. Of course, the first thing that's going through everybody's mind is, all right, we know that WWE Studios, the lockdown film that Dean Ambrose had been out.
Yeah.
Wrapped
filming. Up on Saturday.
It wrapped up this past week on Saturday.
Saturday.
Okay.
Literally the night before.
So they flew Dean Ambrose in to face Rollins, and that's what happened. They shot backstage.
They didn't have a match, but...
Well, out of a limo or out of something, a car or something like that.
Taxi.
Was it the taxi?
Yeah,
okay.
The taxi pulled up.
Showed up backstage. Perfect timing, right?
It's kind of funny.
Rollins is out in the ring.
Yeah.
Perfect timing.
I issue a challenge to anybody in the back. He's not even in the back, but the cab pulls up just in time for the open challenge. He didn't hear. How would he even know?
Does the cab have like a television in the back?
It
where
must, because if you're in a cab and you're driving to the arena and you're not watching the show, how do you know to run out to the ring immediately? Because
right then and there,
you even know he's going to be in the ring. Like, wouldn't you run backstage? Where's that motherfucker? Where? Oh, he's out.
Where
the
is
ring.
He?
All right, now I'm going.
Where
to the
is
ring,
he?
You know,
the cab driver must have been giving him updates.
He was
something
blowing
like that,
it, yeah.
Right?
Tipping him off.
All right, so anyways, he comes out, they brawl, Triple H, Stephanie McMahon, they wind up coming out, all the agents, right, Dean Malenko.
I know one of the agents was Jamie Noble, because he fucking, like...
They were trending!
Jamie Noble like speared him and shit. Like,
oh yeah,
fucking took him down, and then they put like zip ties on him. You know, like the cops do.
Yep.
Dragged his ass to the, you know. So
the agents were trending on Twitter. Segment.
Noble was the one that got real physical. He did it again on Raw. He put him in like a fucking choke, standing up.
Noble's a bad bitch.
Giving Noble a little push.
Yeah, right.
Badass agent, I guess. And Noble's what? This tall?
Ambrose, yeah, kind of a little bit. Ambrose is a fucking star, man.
He's got something very different about him. Yeah, the pop was great. The absence makes the heart grow fonder. And he's only been gone a couple weeks.
That's what it is. You know. Everybody wanted him. Even while Seth Rollins was cutting that promo, the crowd's chanting, "We want Ambrose.
Yes.
We want Ambrose."
They knew
They knew what was going down. All right, so Seth Rollins, Dean Ambrose didn't really happen. Like you said, they came out.
Carry them off.
All right. So, by the way,
we said, just in case.
At this point, we did our predictions on Sunday afternoon.
Reigns and Rollins was supposed to happen. We knew it wasn't, but we said just in case they do a fill in, and it's Ambrose and Rollins.
Right. I picked Rollins. You picked Ambrose. Yeah. It was a no finish. I don't know.
Ambrose got the better of him. I think I should get a point for that one.
A point for that?
No, I'm trying to.
Come on. He was taken out. So Rollins was left standing there, like, "Yeah, motherfucker,
yeah, but who won the fight?
You're out."
Rollins won the battle, but he won the war.
After it was over, Ambrose was taken to the back, and Rollins was standing there.
They needed security to get Ambrose off of Rollins because he was beating him up so bad.
Oh, stop it. Rollins.
If there was a referee,
point for Clark.
If there was a referee in an octagon, they would have stopped the fight. That would have been a TKO. He was out.
Get the fuck out of here.
He was out.
All right, we had Mark Henry and Rusev. Listen, I know you are going to jump on my case, and it's fine. I'm going to let you do it.
Oh yeah.
Listen.
Oh my God.
I said going into this match. Okay, let me see what the people in the chat room think.
You can get me back when we run down Raw. Same people too, Henry and Rusev.
No doubt. But here's the deal. Rusev, in recent weeks, we've seen it time and time again. Rusev has been getting the upper hand, right? Over and over and over, Rusev always comes out on top. They did a match with, who was at the last pay-per-view? It was Rusev and somebody. Swagger, right? And you thought, okay, it's a flag match, so the Americans have to win here, right? You've got to look. We're Americans, the majority of WWE
audience.
It
needs to be pointed out, though. We thought a flag match, because the point is you can't, well, you disagree, but you can't beat Rusev yet. And if it's a flag match, you're not technically beating him. You're just taking a flag off a fucking pole, and then you win. You didn't actually make him pin. You didn't pin him or make him submit.
Right.
So you didn't really beat him yet. You technically won a match because of the way the rules are, because it was a gimmick match, but the flag match turned out. The only way you win is by pinfall or submission. Had we known that.
My whole thing is, all right, Rusev has been getting the upper hand over and over again. So eventually, somebody is going to come in and be that guy to say, "I represent America. America wins this time." It's a feel-good moment, if you will. This cocksucker Russian motherfucker has been coming out and just ripping America, this, that, and the other thing. That feel-good moment, who's it going to be? I thought Mark Henry, Rusev going into Night of Champions, upper hand over and over and over. Mark Henry was going to be the guy that says, "That's it. You know what? I represent America. I get it, and that's it." It makes sense.
If you're going to
you get that good moment
because the guy that beats Rusev, it either needs to be a guy you want to make,
okay,
or a guy you want to build up again. Like, I'll tell you right now, who's going to be the guy to beat Rusev?
Who? Cena.
John Cena.
If they're going that route,
they will eventually.
Cena's
always pro-American. He's like the new Hulk Hogan and shit.
But you're eventually gonna have that moment where Rusev, it just blasts America week after week after week, and there's going to be that one guy that finally comes out and shuts him up. And I thought,
why would it be an aging veteran that's about to retire?
Because I didn't know that they were going to go Rusev Cena at this point.
Well, no, even still, if you're going to build up this guy as undefeated for so long, and he's killing all these Americans, and he's the fucking dastardliest heel because he's fuck you America, this and that. The guy that beats him needs to be like a Reigns or somebody you want to make a star, an Ambrose, somebody you want to make a star, or like a Cena, the top American guy in the company. who finally came through for the country.
But I know how WWE books, and they want that feel-good moment eventually.
You would get that with those scenarios. Reigns, Ambrose, Cena.
Yeah, I like the
Why
fact...
Why give it to Henry?
No, but it's been going on for a couple of months now, so I thought, all right, enough is enough. This guy's been going for like 2 months straight. He's been destroying people, walking over people, dissing America. This is coming to an end at Night of Champions. Didn't happen. And then it didn't happen last night on Raw either. So, all right, so you picked Rusev, and...
I thought that was the easiest one to pick, too.
I didn't. I really thought I was right there. And then last night on Raw, I thought I was right again. I got fucked there, too. But anyway, so you are... Let's see. Hold on. You got that one.
1-0.
We both got that one. So...
2-1.
Rhodes Brothers both got that. Got that, and I got that.
Okay, 3-1, 3-2, 3-3. We're 3-3. We're tied.
No, we're not tied. I got Sheamus. I got Miz.
1-2. Rhodes Brothers, you got 3. You got Orton, that's 4.
Okay.
And then if you look at me, I've got 1-2.
You got 3.
And then.
But I had that too.
Or Ziggler.
I had that too.
Okay, yeah, 4-3.
All right, so I'm up by 1.
Yeah.
I'm up by 1 right here. All right,
You haven't got to that yet. That's what threw me off.
Okay, my bad. The next match was Randy Orton, Chris Jericho. This was an awesome match, man.
I don't remember it that well.
This was a really good match. Orton hit a DDT, and then out of nowhere, Jericho kind of countered it with a code breaker.
I remember that, the code breaker. Okay, yeah.
Right. They went back and forth. Jericho goes up to the top rope, was off the top rope. Orton tries to catch him, and instead hits an RKO for the 1-2.
As he was coming down,
kind of caught
him. I think I was eating dinner during that match. RKO. Just doing shitty updates.
It makes sense. I mean, we both picked Orton here. Jericho's leaving WWE. I'm not going to give Jericho a win on the way out of the company, right? I mean, you've got to put over the guy that's going to be there long term. So
technically, that would be the easiest one to predict.
That would have been the easiest one. We had Paige against AJ Lee and Nikki Bella for the Divas title. You and I both picked Nikki Bella.
We had the same feeling on that one.
We had the same exact thought.
I'm surprised they didn't do it.
You know, Nikki Bella's been kind of the focus of the Divas division. God, we're going to get into Raw last night.
Good Lord,
that segment was terrible between the But you and I both thought that Nikki Bella was going to wind up... it looks like they're going to continue.
Nikki Bella, champion against Brie, and the Bellas fight for the title.
Correct.
And the twins against each other, and then AJ and Paige go off their big enough names that they don't need a title to make the program.
Correct.
I guess they thought the opposite. AJ and Paige are the real Divas. So they should be fighting for the title because they're the best
Divas. They should be the ones with the titles.
This is a program because they're twins. That's enough. That's all they need.
It was the complete opposite where WWE would do Nikki Bella and Brie Bella, the sisters. They got a rivalry.
Twins fighting each other.
Right.
That's enough. You don't need a title.
You don't need a title.
But I thought they would give it to them to make it bigger.
Right.
You know, more important.
And then we had Brock Lesnar against John Cena for the WWE World Heavyweight title. We all know what happened here, right?
We're over the hour mark.
Disqualification. I know, we're going to break right now. Disqualification, John Cena wins.
What did you think
winning
of the match, though?
I thought it was pretty good, to be honest with you.
Yeah, they started off the opposite. Like, Lesnar, if you remember at SummerSlam, within like fucking 20 seconds hit the F5 on Cena.
Right.
In this match, Cena hit the attitude adjustment within like 20 fucking seconds on
Lesnar. A couple of times, right?
Well, the first one he hit, he only got a 1 count.
Right.
And then when he hit it again, he got a 2 count. And in the third time, he didn't even pay. He switched it to the STF.
Right.
Lesnar is struggling. He gets to the ropes, but Cena yanks him back. He's struggling. He goes to get the ropes. He yanks him back. And I'm sitting there thinking, you motherfuckers, you're going to get Cena. And then in comes...
So you did think about it for a second.
Read my column, and I even told you. I was scared to death that you were... Not that you were going to be right, but that they were going to do the dumbest thing ever. And after doing all this, killing the streak of Taker... Squashing their top guy and Cena in his Lesnar's first title defense.
Right.
He's going to lose?
Yeah.
That's retarded, but I was so scared the way the booking was leading up to the... Which we didn't get to cover a lot because we missed 2 weeks, but...
Right.
It really seemed like they were building towards Cena winning.
Really,
and I was like, oh my God,
man.
You idiot motherfuckers. But
going into the pay-per-view, they made Cena look ridiculously strong. Like, I'm a new guy. I'm not going to be the same guy.
And that was all
that
Vince.
You saw, right?
Apparently, the creative team didn't want to do some of that shit. And Vince was like, no, we got to make Cena whole again, you know?
All right. So after it's over, right? They do the DQ.
Rollins came in.
Seth Rollins comes out. Okay. Seth Rollins comes in with the Money in the Bank briefcase, right?
And it's a curb stomp on Lesnar.
Yeah. Who was down. Then goes to the outside.
That gives Cena the win.
Via DQ. So it makes sense there. Then he goes out and he says, I'm cashing in. Here's my briefcase. I'm cashing in right now. Justin Roberts gets on the microphone and says, Seth Rollins is cashing in his Money in the Bank briefcase, right? So right then and there, the bell should ring, okay? It should ring right when Justin Roberts says he's cashing in right now. Ding, 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 ding. Instead, the bell doesn't ring. And Rollins says,
my thought is this, and I'll make it quick because I know we're running. There should be two things that happen when you cash in a briefcase. When you hand it over, okay, you've handed it over. That doesn't mean anything yet. The second they make the announcement, this man, Seth Rollins, has cashed in his Money in the Bank briefcase. That should be officially, you've cashed
it
in, you've lost the briefcase. But the match itself, okay, the bell hasn't rang yet. All right, so the match hasn't started yet. You don't get to beat the guy that's already beaten up and laid out. Once they ring the bell, then the match starts. But the fact that the bell didn't ring shouldn't mean, oh, he didn't cash in. I'm trying to explain.
He gave him the briefcase.
There's two things.
They announced that the match was.
But I'm saying, here's what I'm saying in the sentence. He cashed in his briefcase. That's cashed in. Okay, the match hasn't started. I just forgot it again. I had a perfect way to say it.
I'm not saying what you're saying.
I'm saying it's two different things. A, you cash in the briefcase, and then B, the match starts. You know that you've cashed in the briefcase for.
Okay.
But once you cash in the briefcase, it's cashed in. Once the bell rings, then the match itself starts, but it's not like...
I get what you're saying.
He's cashed it in. It's done. You can't take it back. But okay, the match hasn't started yet because the bell hasn't rang. That doesn't mean you should be able to say, oh, never mind, I don't cash
it
in. You've already cashed it in.
You've already given your briefcase away. As soon as that briefcase leaves your hands and you say, I am cashing in,
I'm okay with that.
When they make the announcement, you can't get it back.
Seth Rollins has cashed in his briefcase.
Right.
If you spend money at something, you know, or at a store or something, once they put it in the cash register, you have spent your money.
I like that pun.
You know what I mean?
I like that pun.
It's not a pun. It's an analogy, but yeah.
Analogy.
Yeah. Okay. But no, I just thought it was just a shitty way to do it, and it leaves a bad taste in your mouth going off the air. You know, they don't give you a clean finish, then they don't give you a clean cash in. There's like two non-finishes in a row.
Right.
And then we go off the air, and
we've seen it time and time again where
we didn't mention this during the show. They mock the fans. If you spent $55 for
we'll
save that for hour two.
They did it on Raw last night.
They had
again.
A graphic and everything on that
they
one.
They did it on Raw last
night. Like a bar. This high, $55. This high, $10. What do you get for $55? You get a pay-per-view.
Dude,
for $10, you get a pay-per-view and five other pay-per-views.
They mocked the fans that paid $54, but they also gave a major fuck you to the pay-per-view companies saying, why would you spend $54 right now? Did you really pay $54 for this pay-per-view?
It's like this.
Why get it for $9.99 on the network?
Why give these assholes at In Demand $55 to see the show when you can give us $10 to see the show and a bunch of other shit?
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly. So, predictions. Winner.
Right there. Chicken dinner.
Alright. We're going to be back.
Rapid fire.
For our numero dos. Submit your rapid fire questions. Tell them how they can submit the rapid fire questions. You can go to my Facebook page, facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR, facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Submit your rapid fire questions. There's going to be a post up there.
Yes.
Make them in a short rapid fire. How does it go?
Ladies and gentlemen, we want you to participate in the rapid fire.
Oh, yeah.
Here in our numero dos. You log on to facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR, that's facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR. Once you get there, the top post will ask you to submit your rapid fire questions and comments. We will answer them in a rapid fire style fashion here in hour number two.
Try and
keep them brief. Ooh. We don't want to be reading short stories. Quick hitters, rapid fire, hour number two. Matt Boone, Ryan Clark will be back. Take us to the break right after this.
You already did. We'll be back. Matt Boone. They say we're not doing so well tonight. They said we took 2 weeks off. They said
we're feeling a little rusty.
Feeling a little bit rusty tonight. So I say for our numero dos, we about to tear this motherfucker up.
I say we're gonna kick a little bit of some bitch's ass.
We can kick some ass.
Some asses.
We're gonna be taking your live phone calls. We're doing the rapid fire. Yeah, just put it up on Facebook. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Your live phone calls as well. 518-712-3070. 518-712-3070. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's crack-a-lacking?
Hello, guys.
Hey now.
Hey now. Jackie.
What's going on?
You gotta tell us what's on your mind this week, Jackie. Welcome back.
Well, I watched Night of Champions. I was quite impressed. Night of Champions, in my book, was not that bad of a pay-per-view, because I saw the one from last year because I ordered it, and that one kind of did not do too well. But this year's was very exciting, even knowing that Cena should have won the title, and in my book, Cena should be champion right now. But we can thank Seth Rollins for that.
Well, we can thank
Seth Rollins for that. But she brings up a good point. We said after the show we talk about whether we thought it was a good show or not. Did you think it was a good show?
I did.
Now that we run it down, there was definitely a couple of good matches. I didn't like the Florida Georgia Line and them ignoring the Miz Ziggler. I thought the double non-finish at the end was total shit. But other than that,
the matches were really good.
Yeah, the Usos match in the Rhodes Brothers, the Sheamus Cesaro, I thought was out of this world good.
Was awesome.
Yeah, there was some good shit in there, you know.
Even you know what else I want to say?
The Ambrose return was something.
Real quick, the NXT TakeOver 2 special that happened.
We haven't been on since then.
Wow, that show was unbelievable. If you guys have the WWE Network and you haven't watched NXT TakeOver 2, I'm telling you, go back and watch that. I marked out like a motherfucker in it. It was awesome, man. I learned a bunch of new guys, their gimmicks and things like that.
Hideo with Tommy?
Awesome. Yeah. It was great. Well, that's Kenta's new ring name, which I don't like.
That's where he revealed it.
They should have kept Kenta as Kenta, in my opinion. But I understand the licensing rights and everything else, where if he leaves WWE, he can take that name. Anyways, so Jackie, what else? How about Monday Night Raw last night? That's what we're going to transition into here in just a second. What'd you think of
I'm gonna give last night's Raw an A+. I think it was very exciting.
You said A+?
I think
A+.
Did you say A+? Did you say A+ or B+?
A+.
A+. Okay, explain. Go ahead.
Okay. Well, all right. Here's how I see it. Now that the thing with Henry and Rusev has ended, I think he's gonna go after Sheamus for the U.S. title.
That makes sense. U.S. title. Yeah.
Jackie, I got somebody in the chat room wanted to ask you, Dan Green 420. He wants to know, did you pay $9.99 for Night of Champions, or did you pay $54.99? What'd you pay?
I have automatic renewal, so I'm gonna have it for probably the rest of my life because when I found out that this was coming out, I'm like, yes, definitely, I want it, because a lot of that stuff happened back from when I was little, because I went to the SummerSlam 93 up in Auburn Hills with my mom and my grandma and my cousin, because that was actually my very first live wrestling event, and I was 6 or 7 at the time, and I really don't remember much about that night, because I was sitting up, way freaking high, and I'm like, I can't see anyone. They were like little dots, and I'm like, this is I should be sitting closer, because I watched the majority of the show on the big screen, and I'm like, okay.
What,
we've all had bad seats.
I know, we've all had bad seats here and there, you know what I mean? It happens. What are you going to do? Yeah. So real quick, thoughts on Raw last night, real quick.
I thought it was an excellent show. In my book, it was an excellent show. I was pretty shocked that Ambrose got out of the locked room, and I'm like, okay, what's going to happen next? Because I smell something big about to go down.
I think so too, Jackie. I think so too. Hey, we'll talk to you next week, all right? Thanks for the call. We appreciate it. A lot of phone calls to get to tonight. Be good.
Okay, Yeah, I gotta email you. I gotta ask you something later, so I'll email you later, Ryan. Okay.
All right, sounds good, Jackie. Have a good week. All right.
All right.
Bye.
Thanks for the call. Yeah, we have to get. I guess we're going chronological order, but that magician trick of Ambrose being locked in a room and then magically being next to the announce table with nobody in the arena knowing.
Oh, I know.
The announcer's sitting right there. They don't know that he's the... How did he do it?
Right.
Yeah, no, that's getting into a silly kind of territory there to where he's magically appearing under blankets after being locked in a room that's being guarded.
Like, how did he get out there? And how did he know...
It was some David Blaine Chris
Angel
shit.
With a taxi cab coming up backstage at Night of Champions. How did he know with the exact timing.
That's a good point.
Right when to show
so
up.
For
right?
The last so two nights in a row, he's now the magician, Dean Ambrose.
David Blaine.
Yeah.
David Blaine, right. But anyways, we'll run down the high points and the low points.
What did you think of
Monday
the show?
Raw
we
last
talked
night.
About it. We thought
you
it
know what? I
good.
Thought it was a pretty good show, to be honest. With the lack of star power, if you will,
yes.
Chris Jericho, Paul Heyman, people like that,
yes.
You know, I thought it. I mean, we'll run down the high points and the low points here. But they kicked it off last night. It was Dean Ambrose. He opened up Monday Night Raw. He goes over what happened at the Night of Champions pay-per-view and why he's been absent
basically
from
Raw. He says he's
going to
do a sit-in, and he's going to sit there until Rollins comes out.
He is not leaving. Reminded me of CM Punk sitting down in the middle of the ring, Indian style, and say, I am not leaving.
Yeah, he went and grabbed the chair, opened it, sat it down, sat there, and instead... Cena comes out.
Right.
So when Cena comes out, Ambrose had some great one-liners there.
Like, Ambrose
don't
is
give
good.
Me a reason not to like you, John, or something like that was one of them. And
it was good.
In that segment. Yeah.
They went back and forth. Cena cut that promo, basic Cena promo. Cena was pretty good last night,
pretty
though,
good.
On the mic, and eventually they were just about to get into it.
Yeah.
Or did they get into it?
Well, here's what happened. He says, don't give me a reason not to like you, and this and that, and blah, 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 and then Cena starts talking, and then, long story short, Ambrose said, I told you not to give me a reason, something like
that's
that,
what it was, something
and
like
then, so they both fucking, decide they're gonna get it on, they start taking their shirt off, their jackets off,
and
they're getting ready to go,
Triple H is
bow down to the king,
right.
Triple H comes out with the entire authority,
right,
and he gets ready to make a match, and before he can even make it, Cena says, is it Ambrose?
It was Ambrose. Ambrose said, you know what? Screw it. If you're not going to come to the ring, I'm coming to get
you. It was Cena.
It was Ambrose.
It was Cena. And Ambrose followed.
No,
it
Cena
was,
followed.
It was Cena.
Ambrose was out there. Ambrose was the one that was calling out Rollins.
Yeah, I know.
So,
was Cena, though. Because he screwed him out of the title. They were both calling out Rollins. That was the thing. It was Cena that dropped the mic and discharged, and Ambrose went with him. I promise you. Go to the chat.
Let's go to the chat. Who dropped the microphone? Who dropped the microphone and said, you know what? Screw it. It was Ambrose. Ambrose was the one that originally called him out. Ambrose is the one that's in the ring.
He was out there first.
Right, but he's in the ring. He's the one that really wants him bad. He's the one that really wants him, not John Cena.
Cena and Ambrose followed. Now shut up and let's finish Roy.
No,
it
was Ambrose.
It was Cena, bro.
It was Ambrose.
I'm telling you
it was Ambrose.
I'm trying to tell you some things here, man.
People in the chat room.
It was Cena. There you go. There's another Cena. Who was wrong and who was right?
Oh, God.
Say it. Say it.
All right. You were right. I was wrong.
So they charge after him up the aisle. Fucking Rollins gets away. They end up in the parking lot.
Who cares?
End up in the parking lot.
No.
Rollins jumps some guy that's loading his trunk up, knocks him out, takes his car, but the trunk's still open. So Ambrose hops into the trunk, and as Rollins is driving off, Ambrose falls out of the
that
trunk.
That was cool, man.
That was kind of dangerous, too.
it was pretty dangerous.
It looked cool, so yeah. And
Ambrose picks up the suitcase, fucking throws
it, and he turns around like smirks at Cena.
Gives him a smirk,
right. Commercial. But long story short, Triple H makes two matches for later in the show. Cena versus Orton, and this is what's interesting, and Ambrose versus Kane, and then prior to Raw, WWE had sent out an official tweet on their official Twitter account announcing Ambrose versus Orton.
Not only an official tweet, they put a graphic on WWE.com as well, okay? And then as Raw is airing, I go to WWE.com to see if that graphic is still up during Monday Night Raw. It's still up.
Is it? I didn't check.
But they've changed it, and there's a little blurb next to it that now says, although originally scheduled was Dean Ambrose, authority has decided to switch things up.
Well, we had heard
made
that
a late change.
They were rewriting the show as it was going on.
Right.
That's how late they were. I mean, you know, they were, as the show was going on, they're still changing shit that's going to happen later.
Paul Heyman was originally booked, as we put up on the website just a couple hours ago, Paul Heyman was booked to come out and cut a promo regarding Brock Lesnar, you know, basically defeating John Cena, even though he lost
still
by DQ.
Champ.
Paul Heyman was going to come out and cut a promo, exactly, about Lesnar still being champion. And Heyman never even appeared on Raw, and this was 2 hours before Raw. You're talking like 6 p.m. when Raw is supposed to go live at 8 p.m. Eastern time. Right.
And that, I had heard flat out, while the show was going on, they were still making changes.
Still making changes
so
during
the show.
So
that's how late they rewrite. And not every week, but it's becoming more and more of a thing where they're getting into WCW territory where announcers are going to go to the ring not even knowing what's going to happen. And,
exactly.
And they'll just get told in their headset, hey, this is coming up. Oh,
do
okay.
You let me say this. Do you agree with that, or do you think that WWE should have a long-term plan set in place and go with it? You can make little tweaks here and there, but have a long-term booking plan in place.
For the main top storylines, you should have it planned out in advance. If injuries or whatever happens that change
make
it,
little
you make tweaks here and there.
Correct.
Absolutely.
Correct.
The week-to-week TVs, pay-per-views, you should plan out, you know, try at least have an idea.
Right.
And try and get to that idea. Maybe the crowd reactions will be such that, you know, oh, we should go this way instead of that way because this guy's getting over more than we thought. You can do stuff like that, but you should have an idea of what you want to work to. Like, they always have that with Mania. They always have in mind what the main event of WrestleMania is going to be, and then they work backwards.
I think the problem with WWE is they have a long-term plan set, okay? And it looks great on paper, right? And then they need to go with it. But I feel like they get to television every week, and they tweak things, and they overbook it.
They overthink.
And when you overthink, and you overbook, and you tweak things, go with your original plan,
you know,
make little changes, but don't change big time matches and things like
major
that.
Major stuff.
Where the major things.
Yeah.
You've got to go with that. And when you overbook and you overthink, your overthinking becomes a negative.
Yeah.
It's
counterproductive.
Yes.
But exactly. The thing I was going to say is, I'm stalling because I'm trying to remember, is
it's every single week.
The reason why. Do you know why? That it's because there's too many goddamn writers. That's why they keep having these changing, overthinking, changing their mind last minute. They've got too many goddamn writers. I think there's too many writers, so there's too many different ideas coming around. Back in the day, you had one or two main guys, and then Vince would oversee it, change the little things here and there. But he had, like, it was Vince Russo and Ed Ferrara, the Attitude Era. You had two guys that were writing your show every week. Vince would read it, and he'd say, oh, let's change this. But if you have 20 guys, then they've all got their 10, own...
15 guys in a room
every
week.
You've got their own opinions, their own ideas. This guy doesn't like that guy. This guy doesn't like that guy. So they have a thing. Like, there's just too much shit.
There's too much
stuff. It needs to be more simple.
Right.
That they act like, well, we need to be like a movie. Or not like a movie. Like a TV show where we have multiple writers and this and that. You guys are a wrestling show.
If you've got...
Period.
If you've got...
Entertainment. Yeah, but you're a wrestling show. Keep it simple.
Right.
Kiss.
Right.
Keep it simple, stupid. Kiss.
Right.
That's what they need to do. They need to keep it simple, stupid.
You've got 10 to 15 guys shooting off ideas in a room, trying to book for Vince McMahon. And when you take all those ideas, every guy has a different idea.
You take
all those guys that have a different idea, and it all comes together and becomes a big clusterfuck. And then Vince has to approve it. It's just like
the thing is, you didn't explain it, but I know what you mean. You say they're writing for Vince McMahon. They're trying to write what they think he's going to like, not what the crowd seems to be reacting to every week. Let's write something that Vince will say, yeah, that's good, not something that the crowd wants.
If they don't, Vince is going to change it anyways. So you've got to write for what Vince wants. Caller, you are live on WZL TV. What's going on?
What's going on, guys? Welcome back.
Thank you, brother.
Hey, two quick things. I know you guys aren't into the Jesus that much, but what do you guys think about, so it looks like we're going to see like a total now badass heel Paige, no more of her being friends with, because she was on commentary last night and she's got a totally different look now. She's dressed in all black, she had like black gloves on, and she was basically saying like on commentary, we're not friends anymore. it's my time now, and so, and I think her being like a full-fledged, like, actual heel and no more of the skipping and stuff, I think with the character that she has, when she gets pissed or mad, like, when she does mic work, I think she can be a pretty good heel. So, what do you guys think about that? I know you guys don't really get into the Divas that much, but I think I'm a huge fan of hers, and I think now that she's actually going to be like a full heel, I think that plays pretty well to her character.
Yep, thanks for the call, man. That's a good point. Yeah, I think it's the next logical step. They're frenemies. They're, you know, a little flirtatious here, a little flirtatious there. Frenemies, enemies, but they're friends. They like each other, but they want the same thing, the title. Now it's getting to where it should be, to where, all right, the frenemies thing is going its course. Now it's, you know what? I want to kick her ass. That's my title. She stole it. It's okay to be frenemies when you're the champ and your enemy slash friend wants what you have, but you have it. Once you lose it, and you're the heel,
right?
Well, now we're not friends anymore. She's got what I want, and I'm kicking that bitch's ass, and I'm taking it back.
Right.
I think
right.
It's nice to go more serious with it. So yeah.
I think they're bringing Paige in the same way they did AJ Lee with the whole crazy gimmick. You know, AJ came in; she was a crazy character.
Well, what he was saying is, he's saying they're kind of dropping that now, and they're going to her being more serious.
She's going to be a more serious,
more
heel.
Of a straight
right.
heel, yeah.
Right. Right.
Which I think is that's the next logical step in the way their storyline's been going.
Right. Let's see. Back to Monday Night Raw last night.
We shouldn't skip that. That's kind of important. Backstage, Orton and is it Orton and Kane?
Rollins, right?
Orton and Kane are both there.
Orton's,
I believe,
upset that Rollins.
Yeah, and they're both they're upset that, what did they say? Because that's when Triple H made the matches. Orton, Cena, and Ambrose and Kane,
right.
And they said you guys need to quit starting fire. Or Rollins, I think, was the guy that's doing it. You need to quit starting fires that we have to put out. Like, basically,
right.
Keep causing all these problems and assuming we'll fix it. Mm-hmm. You know, it's getting old. And, you know, so that's kind of a subtle, maybe Orton's turning face kind of thing in the future. Maybe not now, but it's certainly
it's a seed planted that if
they want to go that way, they've got a story that would make sense because
he
gets fed up with having to do their dirty work.
Rollins, right.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, no, the authority. He's getting
Triple H,
yeah.
Rollins, all of them, right?
Yeah,
Kane
in
and everybody else, right?
Well, I think Kane seems to be part of it with Orton. They both seem to be aggravated. Yeah,
with,
we're the hitman.
Right.
You guys piss people off and then expect us to kill them. You know what I mean?
I agree. Mm-hmm. We had this is the rematch from Night of Champions, right? Dolph Ziggler.
Fucking great match too.
Another good. I mean, Night of Champions is pretty fucking good, but Florida Georgia Line ruined it, man.
You need commentary to make a match.
Exactly.
For a good match to be great, you need the announcers telling the story.
Exactly.
And they were ignoring the shit out of it. So.
And the fact that they had a title change planned at Night of Champions and still went out there and had that country group
Florida
Georgia and just completely ignored it. I mean, at least last night on Raw, they, you know, did the title change, but we had commentary. We had good commentary during it.
Was somebody on commentary during this or no?
No, this was one-on-one. Paige was on commentary later in the night, which was what he was talking about the last time. All right,
But anyways, this match was phenomenal. And like you said, the Night of Champions match, I would even say it was okay, and if the announcing was there, it would have been good.
Right.
So it just came off bad because of the way they announced. The last night's match on Raw was a damn good match.
Very good.
Was kind of great because of the commentary,
right?
You know, push it over the top. Not that they were like they were still doing their arguing amongst each other and that dumb shit that they do. But
what do you think about them? You know, at Night of Champions, they take the title off Ziggler, and then the following night on Raw, they put it right back on Ziggler. What do you think about that? Was that just done?
That might have been one of those
try to get, you know,
late rewrites because they're rewriting. We don't have a lot happening here tonight because it's such of a light. Let's do a title change. You know, maybe that could have been that.
It could have been something like that. But I thought that, you know, the way that they've been pushing The Miz in recent weeks, man, I thought that, you know what, they're going to give him a decent title run here. As, you know, they've got the new gimmick. They've got the whole Hollywood thing going.
Yeah.
New entrance.
That seems to be more of a comedy
stuff.
Sideshow kind of thing, though. I don't know if they would take it seriously.
Right.
Whereas Ziggler, God forbid, you know how they feel about him.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
They realize we don't have a lot of options. We got to start making stuff. Like, name the top baby faces in WWE right now.
There's not many, man. There's
not
many
at
all. Ambrose.
Reigns is on the shelf. You got Ambrose. And then after that, he's going, well, who do you got?
That's about it.
Who's your next one?
I know.
So, you know, you might turn Orton babyface. You might
actually
go with a guy like Ziggler.
Every time when Ziggler's music hits, how big of a fucking pop this
he is. Well, he's over like Rover.
Time.
Dude, if they would go with him,
huge.
He'd be great. You remember when he won the title the night after WrestleMania a couple
years ago? Oh, my God. It was the loudest pop we've heard.
One of the loudest pops I've ever heard. Yeah, so, I mean, clearly the fans have made it clear we want this guy as our guy. All they have to do is go with him, and, you know, it should be just fine.
Speaking of pops.
Because he's got the goods to back up the push if they would give it to him. He's clearly got the goods to make it, you know.
Hey, speaking of pops and loud crowds, next week.
What?
Next week, Monday.
Oh, you said they're in Chicago.
Chi-town, baby. Next week.
Oh, boy.
Did you hear the rumors?
Oh, jeez. No, I didn't. Are you going to make up some punk rumors or something?
Punk? You haven't heard the rumors about punk?
Oh, he's coming back.
Raw next Monday?
He's coming back.
Chicago?
Yeah.
It's the rumor.
You're joking, but by Monday, I guarantee you somebody will report it.
I guarantee you. Touching shit.
I'm telling you right now.
Guarantee
Vince McMahon himself could call me up and say, yo, Punk has re-signed. He's going to be back on Monday, and I ain't posting it because I don't believe that shit no more.
I'm done
with it.
I am telling you. And Boone
is that whole Punk thing, by the way, it was a work. The whole thing was a work.
Absolutely.
So this is when they reveal that it was a work. In Chicago, it all makes sense, right, guys? It was a work.
It was a work all the way until now.
Yeah.
I guarantee.
A 9-month work.
I guarantee you. And you know what the reason for it is? You're going to see a report at some point this week on some website. I don't know where it'll be. But somebody will put CM Punk rumored for Raw or CM Punk possible. And you know why they do it?
CM Punk is telling friends.
You know why you're going to see it? To cover their ass. Because if by some slim chance slim chance CM Punk does come back next Monday, I told you so.
Yeah, but
telling you CM Punk is not coming back next Monday.
Shit.
And I don't care who says I'm not putting it up.
I'm not touching it.
Why are we talking about it?
Yeah.
Because you haven't heard the rumors?
Oh, Christ.
Get to our live chat room, WZROnline.com.
Motherfucking.com/chat,
WZROnline.com/chat. Get in there. Lots and lots of people in there, as always, tonight. They came around tonight, though.
Yeah, that's something I don't think we've... Have we talked about it? Because of the 2 weeks... CM Punk has kind of like a legal thing going on with WWE over...
22-page letter,
legal letter, over merchandise, royalties from merchandise sales and shit. And even last night at the 2K15 symposium, or what do they call it, the roster reveal?
Right.
Did you watch it yet? I watched it last night.
It was old, though. It was from months ago.
It was clearly old because Reigns was sitting there, but it didn't seem like
it was
that old. They
did it at SummerSlam, man.
That's not months ago. That's last month.
Alright, I'm
either way, I'm just saying they would reveal different people that's going to be part of the game, and they would play their music, show a picture of them as they look in the game, like their cartoon version of them in the game.
Right.
And everybody gets, you know, this guy gets a louder pop because he's like Cena gets a louder pop because he's a bigger name than Ziv, you know, or whoever.
Yeah.
And they throw a Punk up and they fucking muted the crowd, so you didn't.
I didn't see it, but I had put something up on the website where a fan emailed and said that's what they did last night.
I told you that
last
night.
Were they
you were taking a piss and you were going to sleep, remember? And I said, dude, because you had heard, the door right there to the bathroom's right there, and my computer right, so he can hear it. And when he was done, I had the piss, so I go in there, and he's going back in his room, and I said, did you hear that in there? No, what? I said, they're doing the 2K15 thing, and they just had Punk come up, and they fucking muted the audience and shit. So, it was blatantly obvious, too.
So the audience was cheering for CM Punk, and they muted the audience? Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
They didn't so much mute it as they clearly post-edited it. Like, everybody would get, like, if Cena was like, yeah, you hear a couple hundred people cheering. You know, some guys louder than others, like I said, because bigger names.
Right.
But when Punk came up, you didn't hear shit.
Nothing.
And his
Nothing.
Music's playing like everybody else's, the picture's up.
Oh, it's a shame they can't do that every time AJ Lee comes out on Raw or a Night of Champions.
That poor girl.
Every time AJ Lee comes out to the ring, CM Punk, you know what I mean?
Imagine next week. Fucking
Man. I don't even know.
But she'll be coming out with Punk, because you heard the rumors, right?
You heard the rumors?
Yeah.
Oh, you did hear the rumors.
No, that's new. You heard the rumors.
No,
the updated rumors. That Punk's...
You said AJ Lee's coming out next week, and I heard the rumors.
He's in the building right now already. He's going to spend the night there until Sunday.
What?
Right, sleeping bag.
What?
Yeah, sleeping bag, cans of tuna. He's good to go. He's camping out till Monday.
All right, here we go. He's camping out till Monday. All right, here we go. Back to Monday night. You guys heard the rumors, right? Back to Monday Night Raw from last night. We had... Jack Swagger defeated Bo Dallas. Something towards the end of this, right? Zeb Coulter came out after it was over, right?
And I'm gonna tell you, I believe all you that Swagger do, just made you tap out.
Zeb Coulter was kind of funny, where he's like, "All you gotta do is believe."
Yeah. You know, he mopped his voice. He said,
right.
"I believe." Just made you tap out.
We had Natalya against Summer Rae. The whole thing here is there was a big old
did you watch Total
fucking
Divas?
Thing, right? Here's the deal, right?
I watched.
Natalya stops the car and gets out, and the whole thing, you cannot. Dude, I'm sitting there thinking, you have got, this is more scripted than the Kardashians or any reality show on television. And then, of course, they follow it up. Right before the match, they said, did you guys see what happened on Total Divas?
Yeah.
You gotta check this out. And they show the clip, obviously. But after it was
over. Last season, Summer went to Natalya's house. And Natalya said she looks like a stripper. She's almost a stripper. So Summer smacked the shit out of her. And they did the same thing on Raw the next night. They had a match with those two. They showed the clip, and then they just dropped it. This, and they even had one thing where Tyson Kidd, who you know Natalya's married to, was helping Summer train, and Natalya got jealous. They showed that clip and had a match. I think it was even a mixed tag with Fandango and Summer versus Natalya and Kidd.
Right.
And then they dropped it. And then last night they did it again, probably, you know, like you just said, and they're probably going to drop it again.
It's so stupid, dude. The whole, I mean, it was all to promote Total Divas, this whole match last night between...
You don't watch Total Divas, do you?
I watched the highlight clips that come out the following day on Monday, on Monday morning, but that's about it.
So I've watched every episode of every season so far.
Are you really into it? I'm not into reality TV,
I like anything wrestling. I like glimpses behind the scenes.
Like the backstage stuff.
I like
stuff,
that
right,
shit, yeah.
Right.
I just rewatched Wrestling with Shadows the other night.
Did you?
The Bret Hart Screwjob documentary,
All right, we had Dean Ambrose against Kane. This ended via disqualification. Right.
Was this the, what was this? I don't remember.
Well, Seth Rollins wound up coming...
Hitting the ring and beating up on him or something?
Coming out here, and then they brawled through the crowd once again. Yeah. Seth Rollins wound up coming out. They brawled through the crowd. It was similar to what they did at...
Jamie Noble choked him from behind.
This is
that's
where the
they
agents
threw him in the
came
room.
Out once again.
And they were backstage with this. I guess maybe after... I don't know. But either long way short, they get him backstage. And, oh, that was it. Backstage, I think Rollins and Kane was like walking around like proud of themselves for beating up Ambrose. And then out of nowhere, Triple H walks up and says, "Watch out!" You know, and then Ambrose nails him from behind.
They come up from
security, chokes him, and Triple H just throw him out of the building. And Stephanie screams, "No! Don't win it! You want to throw him in that room and watch the room!" And she tells Triple, "When's the last time you've seen us throw somebody out of the building and they haven't come back?"
Right.
And Triple's like, "Watch the door!" You know.
Right. Exactly. We had Sheamus and the Usos defeated Cesaro, Goldust, and Stardust. Almost a rematch, I guess, from Night of Champions. I mean, this was obviously a six-man tag team match,
right? It was two rematches put in one.
Two rematches together into a six-man tag team match. One of the Uso guys pinned Goldust, hit a splash off the off the top rope. This is a pretty good match, man.
Sorry, yeah.
Last night on Raw, we had...
You gotta go to the backstage, though, real quick.
Seth Rollins told Randy Orton that he and Kane are going to be at ringside during the main event.
And that they had a...
And they have a big surprise planned.
He was trying to calm Orton down because Orton said earlier, "I'm tired of putting your fires out." And Rollins says, "No, I appreciate what you're doing for me, and just to show my appreciation, there'll be a surprise, and me and Kane will be at ringside to watch your match." And then surprise,
Well, and Orton looked kind of like,
He says, "I like surprises." And then when Rollins went away, he kind of had a look on his. I'm telling you, man, they're doing a slow.
It is. You know what? I'm seeing it. You're right. We had Rusev defeated Mark Henry.
Why did you have to say that? You're right. Jesus Christ. All you have to say is...
he says, "When am I wrong? I'm always right." And
Hold on.
Wait a minute. And then it leads us into our next match of the evening.
I got news for you.
Rusev against Mark Henry.
I'll admit it.
A match that when we were running down Night of Champions, I had to sit here, turn to my left, and say, "You were right.
I didn't pick Mark Henry."
And you know what? I got to do it again right now because I set the boom last night during Raw. This is it. They didn't do it at Night of Champions.
Okay,
Mark Henry's getting them now.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to turn to this son of a bitch right now and say, "You were right. I was wrong."
Yeah, but I was wrong too because I made a point to go in there and I said, I think they're turning Henry heel.
Yeah, you did say that.
The, all right. And they didn't, but I still think that that's because, remember, that we didn't even talk about it. Henry started cutting the promo, and the fans started doing what? And he's like, yeah, I deserve it. Guys, you can what me all you want. It was real sad. And this
How
and
about
that.
Henry crying before during, the national anthem?
On Sunday night, yeah, right. Crying. There's just all these, and this is the kind of stuff he did when he's wearing the big pink sport coat.
Yeah, I got retired. Since I got the kids
turns
at home.
On Cena, and right? It was one of the greatest swerves and retirement swerves of all time.
That was awesome when he did that. Remember that, man?
I see them doing similar shit. They might be turning his big ass heel. I don't know.
Having him pair up with Rusev?
Not pair up with Rusev, but just turn heel and maybe Big Show is one of the next guys that faces Rusev.
Well, I had said to you last night.
And maybe Henry fucks Big Show and then they go off because Henry and Big Show have been friends recently.
I had said to you last night, if they do turn Mark Henry heel, and let's just say this.
Yeah, you went off on a big tangent.
Well, I just said this. Yeah. It wasn't a big tangent. It was just, let's say that they turn Mark Henry heel and they pair him with Rusev.
Yeah.
It would be Rusev and Henry against Big Show and...
Yeah, this
who would be the other big guy? I'm just saying if they did the tag
team
match.
I was explaining to you that I thought it was a heel, and then for you to be able to agree with it, you were like, "All right, so who?" Mark Henry and Rusev versus Big Show, and who? I'm like, "No, you're focusing on the wrong part." I'm not saying they're going to become a tag team, Henry and Rusev. I'm just saying Henry might turn heel.
It wasn't a matter of that. It was just okay. Let's say that they turn Mark Henry a heel.
Yeah.
Okay, and they do that. Obviously, if Mark Henry turns heel. While feuding with Rusev, they're going to be paired together. They're going to be together, at least for the time being.
I didn't say he's turning heel while working with Rusev. I said I see them getting ready to turn him heel by the way he's acting.
Yeah, but where are they going to go with Rusev and Henry right now?
I think that's done, probably.
After last night, you think so?
He beat him twice. Fuck, he made him tap out and then passed him out.
Last night Henry didn't tap. He just passed out like you said, but I don't know. So two clean wins for Rusev and that's it? Henry goes off and just
what? How could he say he deserves a rematch, Henry?
That's true.
How do you justify it? I deserve a rematch because of what? He beat him clean both times, too. Nobody cheated to help him, you know.
That's true. I just, I don't think Henry's done with him yet. I think this might keep going. I don't know.
So who's he going to work with otherwise?
Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
What's going on, man?
How you doing, bro?
First off, I want to touch on something real quick. There's two, little interesting spoilers from SmackDown.
What do you got?
First, Cesaro just won the Intercontinental number one contender's Battle Royal.
A Battle Royal, Cesaro won for the IC title, so it looks like
he's the number one contender, he said.
We just won a Battle Royal at the SmackDown tapings, number one
and,
contender.
I don't know what's going on here, but they just announced Rollins and Cena for Hell in a Cell.
Wow.
Rollins and Cena for Hell in a Cell. That makes sense. That makes sense.
Yeah,
no
but
doubt.
Then what's going on with Lesnar then?
Well, Lesnar's going to be...
How are you going to take it off?
Lesnar's going to be here and there. They announced... Oh, it's not a title match. Rollins and Cena...
He said, what's going on with Lesnar? I'm saying Lesnar probably just doesn't work on himself.
Yeah, Lesnar's probably won't work that pay-per-view. I'm guessing that we'll see Lesnar at Survivor Series. I mean, they could add a number one contender, although Rollins has the briefcase, so that wouldn't make sense if they did a number one contenders. Cena versus Rollins makes sense. Would Ambrose somehow be involved in that?
That's the question. What does Ambrose even
maybe with
do?
A briefcase and a triple threat?
Yeah, they could add Ambrose in there and do a triple threat of some sort, something like that. I haven't seen the SmackDown spoilers yet, dude. So I'll after SmackDown tonight, and then especially after next Monday's Raw, we'll have a much better indication of what they're gonna do. But for them to announce. You know, I mean, that's... So it looks like Cesaro is going to be facing Sheamus, right?
Who did he say?
I see
Cesaro and Sheamus. No. I see is Ziggler.
Or Ziggler, my bad.
So
my
Cesaro
bad.
Cesaro and Ziggler.
Cesaro and Ziggler. And it'll be Cena and Rollins at the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view. Uh-huh. And then you're going to... What match are they going to do in a Hell in a Cell? Are they going to do Cena...
He just said Cena Rollins.
Cena Rollins is Hell in a Cell.
I think that's what he said, right?
Yeah, they announced that it's a Hell in a Cell match, too.
All right.
So
all right.
In the Hell in a Cell. Thanks for the call, by the way. Yeah, but I don't see how they don't add Ambrose, because otherwise, what the fuck's Ambrose going to do? His storyline is clearly Rollins. He's been restrained and thrown in buildings and zip-tied twice and trying to get Rollins, so they can't just ignore it. So, yeah, probably on Monday he'll get added to it, if not tonight during the SmackDown at some point.
Yeah, something like that.
If that's true. I don't even know if that's true. I mean, I trust our callers, but, I don't know.
We had Adam Rose and the Bunny. It looks like the Bunny was played by Justin Gabriel last night. What do you think of the
it's
Bunny?
It's always a high flyer, yeah. Dude, it was right. Sami Zayn was once, and then Justin Gabriel was once.
Is he 54? Are you serious?
Yeah, that's what I was trying to wrap it up.
Wow, okay. Right,
so and then the Bunny and Adam Rose win.
Yeah. The main event of Raw, that's where we're at anyways.
Well, we had the AJ and stuff, AJ and Paige and all that shit, but we talked about that already.
Yeah, John Cena and Randy Orton.
The Bellas, we got to talk about that. Bella
segment. Oh my God, the Bella segment.
I don't want to, but we got
terrible last night. Dude. Yeah. Listen, so that feud started off so goddamn
it
hot.
Didn't do. It was the Bree Stephanie feud.
You're right.
Hot. When once Nikki became part of it, it started going down. And now that Stephanie's out of it, it's fucking in the toilet,
it
bro.
It crashed and burned. Yes. I mean, when Stephanie was a part of it, that first night where Stephanie got arrested, right?
Yeah, when and Bree smacked her from the crowd.
A couple of weeks later, Bree wound up getting arrested, started going downhill. Yeah. Nikki becomes involved eventually.
Then it was just, it sucked from there on. Yeah, and now it's just garbage.
And now Stephanie's out of it, and now it's just Nikki and Brie, and the mic work between those
two. It's atrocious.
It is terrible.
It is ungodly.
It's terrible.
Say, we're going to do adjective.
Atrocious. Ungodly. Good Lord. You got to be fucking kidding.
Horrifying. I mean, it was just terrible. Bad. But,
yes.
So it looks like they're going to fight over the name now because Nikki says, I want to be known from now on as the Nikki Bella, and she wants Brie to drop the Bella name.
Right.
You got married. Why did you take your husband's last name anyway? But it looks like the feud will be another match, or not another match, a match, because they never even fought yet. So
they haven't done the one-on-one.
Yeah, so that'll be the that'll probably be Hell in a Cell, Nikki, Brie, Bella, the winner has to, or the loser has to get rid of the Bella name.
Right.
I'm just guessing, but.
And then John Cena, Randy Orton, we talked about this earlier, man. Dean Ambrose was out at ringside, he was hidden
magically,
underneath.
Somehow, yeah.
Magically appeared, he was hidden underneath the big thing that they had.
That was
I don't know, whatever.
Too much for me, man.
You ready?
Too goofy. Yeah,
you think we can do this in one sentence answers?
Well, we'll see.
We got 17 rapid
fire
questions.
You gotta turn this fucker towards me. I can't read it.
We ready?
Yeah.
We got 4 minutes.
Let's try.
To get through rapid fire.
Anthony Remy says Vince Russo to WWE? Question mark.
No. Jay Mullen, do you think it's possible at Hell in a Cell we get a 6-man Hell in a Cell match for the WWE title? Brock, Rollins, Kane, Cena, Ambrose, Orton.
No, we got Rollins, Cena. He says, congratulations, Matt Boone. You were right with Brock retaining his belt, just like I've been saying for weeks. Clark, sir, you were wrong.
I heard when the announcer says the winner by disqualification.
Yeah.
John Cena.
He said the belt, not the winner of the match. Ian Jones kicking ass in the WZR TV Fantasy League, baby. 3-0. T-shirt update. Ryan, has mine been sent out yet?
Yes, half of them went out last week, and the other half is going out this week. And by the way, your team with Matt Ryan and
is he Jonesy?
Yes.
Yeah, he's got the best team.
Killed it.
Yeah,
killed
he's got
it.
The best team. I thought I did. You're up.
Dan Langren, where's Bray? That was interesting. Wasn't on Raw last
night. Or Night of Champions.
Also, I agree with the fact that Reigns will come back bigger. Lesnar, Reigns, Mania.
That's definitely happening. Yeah. Okay. I wonder what they're doing with Bray, though. That's kind of really strange. They're
weird
killing,
he wasn't on Raw.
They're killing his momentum, man.
Yeah.
I mean, he's really, oof.
Yeah.
Anthony Remy, Selena Gomez or Vanessa Hudgens?
Wow, bro, that's tough. I have an obsession with Vanessa Hutchins.
Hutchins? Is that how you say it?
Hutchins.
I thought it was Hudgens.
H-U-D-G-E-N-S. But I'm also a fan of Selena. I'm going to go Vanessa. I think she's the cooler chick.
I can't answer.
Better body, though, Selena.
There you go.
Ryan Shoptaw, any news on what Angle is going to do now that his TNA contract is expired? His contract expired on Sunday. He said that he was going to make an announcement as soon as it did. We haven't heard that announcement as of now. I think he's going to re-sign with TNA or jump ship to GFW.
I don't know. I hope he goes back to WWE, but I don't know.
And what TNA's new network will be? Rumors that there may be an announcement this week.
That's the rumor, but they've been saying that a lot. Lance Winter, that's for you, man.
Ryan, were you at the Albany Raw when Triple H reformed DX, brought out X-Pac? I was, because I was watching the new DX Monday Night War thing, and it looked like you were in the first row. Probably was, brother, or else that guy was doing one great Ryan Clark impression. Those were back in the days, back in the 90s, when I was at Raw, and I would sleep overnight.
We might be going
tickets
to SmackDown in a couple of weeks.
November
4th? 4th? 5th? Yeah, 4th.
Yeah, that was me, though, yes.
Paul Velasquez, I'm sorry, man. Please, Boone, please discuss these few topics. Thank you. Mark Hunt knocks out Roy Nelson. Yeah, it was a great knockout. uppercut, walk away, knockout, dropped him on his face. Thiago Silva fired from UFC again. He should have been. He's crazy as fucking shit.
Videos came out.
Yeah, there's proof now they can't turn their head, especially with Ray Rice and all that shit. It's just domestic violence. You don't want to have that PR right now.
Right.
Anthony Johnson, same thing. Suspended for domestic abuse. His ex-wife, ex-girlfriend, whatever, came out of the woodwork.
Got to suspend him.
Yeah. Vanelly Silva's lifetime ban. He also retired and trashed the UFC for them treating
not happy.
He treated the, they treat the athletes wrong, but today it came out that the Nevada State Health Commission gave him a lifetime ban. They call it an indefinite suspension, but it basically amounts to a lifetime ban. He was never allowed to fight in the state of Nevada again.
Really?
Which means if he comes back, UFC won't take him because they will never use somebody that
that's the home base,
that,
yeah.
That can't get licensed in Nevada.
Right,
yeah.
Right. Predictions?
Yeah, predictions. I was going to say also, John Jones got fined $50,000 and was given 40 hours of community service for the brawl with Daniel Cormier. Daniel Cormier was fined $9,000.
What?
20 hours of community service for the
brawl. Wait a minute, wait a minute. The Nevada State Athletic Commission,
yeah.
They're not a law enforcement agency. How
they're a governing body.
They can't do community service. That's like being arrested.
I don't know. They can order community service, I guess.
What?
That's the official ruling. It aired on UFC Fight Pass today.
They're not cops.
That's what happened, man.
All right.
Predictions for this Saturday's UFC pay-per-view. Do you know the lineup we've got this Saturday?
Run it down real quick.
Fuck me, dude.
The top events.
The main event sounds like shit, but everything else is awesome. Okay. The main event's Demetrius Johnson versus Chris Cariasso for the UFC flyweight title.
Don't know Chris Carey.
Cariasso, yeah. Not many people do. Eddie Alvarez's UFC debut against Donald Cowboy Cerrone.
Nice.
Conor McGregor, the Irish dude, the crazy
Conor,
Irish dude.
Not Conor the Crusher.
Yeah. Conor McGregor versus Dustin Poirier.
Yeah.
We've got the return of Dominic Cruz after 2 years against Takeo Nogueira. Got the return of Kat Zingano after a couple years against Amanda Nunes. I'm forgetting a big male fight. Who the fuck is it?
Cat fight?
Oh, dude, that's going to bug the shit out of me. Oh, no.
I don't know. I'll run down the next one. You think about it. Brandon Dubb at Bevins. What's the status of Kofi, Big E, Nation of Domination, and will we ever see Ryan do a show without his hat? Second question, no, you will not see me do a show without my hat. And the status of the Kofi, Big E, Nation of Domination, they're still doing it at house shows. Anytime somebody asks on Twitter to Big E or Xavier or Kofi, they all joke around about it. So I don't think that they know, and that's kind of why they're joking around about
there's
it.
There's Tim Kennedy and Yoel Romero, too. There's some other fight. Hold on, go ahead. He wasn't done yet. There was Nate Diaz versus Rafael Dos Anjos. Yeah, Nate Diaz is back.
Back in the UFC?
Yeah, in the UFC, they re-signed him today. Or not re-signed him. They got him to agree to return today. He's going to be fighting in December. By the way, I think you should have your own MMA show so you can run down stuff from the MMA world. We've talked about that.
Steve Williams Jr. is up next. When is Sami Zayn coming into Monday Night Raw or SmackDown? What is the update on Corey Graves? No update on Corey Graves yet.
We've heard that the three that I've heard, Adrian Neville, Sami Zayn, Tyler Breeze, are coming up sooner than later.
They've been backstage at Raw and SmackDown.
Yeah. And they've been going on the road with the live events.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct.
But I've heard that they're coming up soon, like full time.
Very soon.
Yeah.
Very soon.
The Next Generation thing we didn't even talk about. What was that?
They plugged it all week long. All week long. And
Triple H,
nothing.
Everybody. Not like just a couple of reporters. Triple H himself has said, Next Generation, the date. Roman Reigns commented on it. Cesaro commented on it. Sting.
I think it was creative rewrites once again at Raw, and they just got bumped off, and they don't care.
So is it coming?
A whole week? I think it's still coming. I think there was just so many creative rewrites
tomorrow.
What
do you think it is, the Next Generation? Those guys, NXT guys?
I was hoping for like an NXT invasion type angle, like but they've done that over and over and over, so when does it get old? But I think it would work. I think
with the guy, yeah. The
Kevin Steen, Adrian Neville, people like that.
Kenta, yeah, Prince Devitt. Yeah,
man, doing invasion angle.
Dying for those people.
Invasion angle.
Vincent Nugent, Ryan and Matt, what do you guys think about the latest MMA show events from Bellator and UFC Savoir? Were there some good fights on those nights? Thoughts? UFC had what this past weekend? Japan. Yeah, that
we didn't see it because
I watched
it in the morning time. I didn't see it.
I watched the whole thing. Yeah, Mark Hunt.
Did I hear that
Gomi got
November,
knocked out?
Yeah, you said it was a great show.
Yeah, Misha Tate won. There was some great fights.
Did I hear that World Series of Fighting moved an event today? So
yeah.
On the same night, you're going to have UFC,
Bellator,
November 15th,
yeah.
UFC, Bellator, and World Series of Fighting all on the same night, head-to-head.
UFC has Cain Velasquez's return against Fabricio Verdum, heavyweight title fight.
Right.
Bellator has Tito Ortiz and Stephen Bonner. Plus, they got King Mo on that show. Same show. And then World Series of Fighting, plus World Series of Fighting.
Crazy. crazy.
Just made a pay-per-view deal where they're going to revolutionize pay-per-view with some kind of fighter sharing profit thing.
Yeah.
To where, like, any money they make off the pay-per-view somehow gets spread among the fighters instead of the pros. Something.
How can you...
Some
weird shit. Three MMA shows on one night, though?
That's crazy.
That's crazy. Yeah. All right, we got Arturo Velasquez Jr. Who is the bunny? Who is in the bunny costume, and will he be a new guy from NXT? Here's the deal. Last night on Raw, we're going to put an article up after we go off the air here tonight. We believe it was Justin Gabriel. But the rumor is that when he is able to return, Darren Young will be the guy behind
heard,
the bunny. Now, that yeah. could change numerous times.
I've heard a couple of rumors. That I've heard Tyson Kidd has been under it a couple times. Justin Gabriel, Sami Zayn, Adrian Neville, I think. So there's been a bunch of guys that have played it. But yes. Yeah, when they finally do the reveal, will it
do
be,
the reveal,
will it be the debut of an NXT guy? That's a shitty way to debut, if you ask me.
Or will it be Darren Young, and that's... Darren Young dressed up as a bunny. It's kind of a rip.
Gay overtones.
It's kind of a rip, yeah. Let's be honest. All right.
Matt Johnson, NXT TakeOver was awesome. What did you guys think of some of the matches? It was an excellent show. Doesn't that look gay? That's what I said. I think it's a rip.
Absolutely. Yeah.
What did you guys think of some of the NXT TakeOver matches? It was an excellent show from top to bottom. I bet you're an instant fan of Enzo Amore. LOL.
He
Anyways,
was awesome, bro.
I'll have to ask you. Anyways, I see a lot of Piper Pillman and Steve Austin and Ambrose. Do you think he's like a 3-1? First NXT TakeOver, Enzo Amore. What do you think of the matches? What do you think of Enzo Amore?
He's got the New York accent, like, hey, you know what I mean?
Like, and then Italian?
He's got the Italian accent. My bad. Yeah. A lot of people in New York do that. Hey, you know what I mean? And then there's the other guy. There's another dude in the background, like a big, taller guy. I can't remember
big
his
Cass?
Name. But he something like that. But he says,
big
he's got one line that he says over and over. He says, you know what I mean? Hey, you know what I mean? And he just keeps saying
so
something like that. Yes. Yeah, it's awesome. It's fucking great.
Everybody sees a lot of Piper and somewhat more Piper than anything in Ambrose, but I can see the Pillman thing with the loose cannon. They even called him loose cannon recently in Austin with the Rebel. Yeah, so you definitely see that in
talking
Ambrose.
Talking about Ambrose?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, no doubt. Nick Dodge, right?
Yeah.
Nick Dodge. Since Night of Champion has finished, how many people do you think will unsubscribe to the WWE Network? I got to tell you, thinking we were supposed to go into Night of Champions, it was supposed to be this stacked freaking card because
Whoa.
Everybody's...
Can you unsubscribe? Does he mean not sign back up?
Probably not sign
yeah,
back.
Yeah, because that was supposed to be the one where they needed to lure him back because their 6-month subscriptions from the very beginning would
be
up, right?
Right.
How many people are going to sign up again? Oof.
We're going to find out the network numbers during the next conference call.
Well, we won't,
and
because it'll be the international number with it. We won't know how many people we lost, and
that's
I guarantee you it's a lot,
topic,
because the
yeah.
number will be bigger than before, because the international, if we had a separation, this is how many international, this is how many domestic, I guarantee you that
we're not
going
to be able to tell them apart, because WWE's not
that's why they
that
bumped
either.
Up the international, because they knew goddamn
right.
well that fucking after that first.
You're right.
Quarter, and then in the second quarter, and the number only went up by what? It went up by 20,000 after fucking 3 months, was it?
Well, it looked on paper like it went up by like 100,000,
yeah.
but it only turned out to be
like
25,000.
20, 28, 30, yeah,
something
like
that.
That.
Yeah,
so
man.
They knew damn well, oh shit, when that
you
6 month thing is up,
okay.
at our next conference call, it's going to be down,
that's,
not up.
That's all fine, but you know what? Once we get into 2015, after it's already launched overseas, they're going to have WrestleMania. So they're probably hoping we can get through WrestleMania. What happens after WrestleMania 2015? After all the internationals
yeah.
have signed up, after WrestleMania is over, then what happens?
And the thing is,
then
they do month-to-month subscriptions now, too. So it's not like, at least WrestleMania will cover until damn near the end of the year. No.
Right.
Pretty much fucking April or May,
right.
you're going to have to fucking have some great shit to get people to stay or sign up.
We'll
you know.
See what happens. We are at
Vincent Nugent says, I definitely agree with you guys. The NXT special live events are
awesome.
Putting up some fantastic shows from start to finish. Now,
Absolutely.
In your opinion, Ryan and Matt, what NXT live special event do you like the most so far? Arrival, TakeOver, or TakeOver 2, Fatal 4-Way, or even all of them? Explain why as well.
Well, in my opinion,
yeah.
Vincent Nugent, let me tell you.
In my opinion, you didn't write one line like we asked you to, and I don't see a whole I don't see a whole lot of one-liners coming up here in our future.
Vincent Nugent, we got look at all these from Vincent Nugent.
And Chris Brown. All right. My favorite was probably Arrival. I thought Arrival was fucking awesome.
I would say the last one, and I know you didn't
Arrival
see it.
Was Cesaro and Zayn.
I thought the last one, I watched
I didn't
it
see the last
top
one.
To bottom. I thought it was amazing. But
yeah.
the one before that,
with Neville
NXT,
and Zayn?
NXT TakeOver, what was that? NXT?
One was, was it Tyson Kidd and Neville?
It was Tyson Kidd and Adrian Neville was TakeOver 1. And then TakeOver 1 was Cesaro.
TakeOver 1 was Cesaro.
Arrival was Cesaro.
No. The very first one was Cesaro and Zayn. They had that match at Arrival.
Right.
And then, I don't know if it was the main event. Maybe it was...
And then NXT TakeOver 1 was Adrian Neville and Tyson Kidd in the main event. And then NXT TakeOver 2 was the four-way that we just had. Right. I would say NXT...
I like that Cesaro-Zayn match. I thought that was awesome.
Yeah.
But the Neville-Kidd match was fucking great, too. And on that Neville-Kidd...
The four-way NXT TakeOver 2 was awesome.
The Neville-Kidd show, the first TakeOver, they had that Tyler Breeze and Sami Zayn match.
Right.
That was off the fucking charts, too.
To be honest with you, all three of them...
They've been great.
Amazing. Yep. What do we got next, man? Christopher Brown, a friend of mine... Who's on his honeymoon, but who's a regular listener, wanted me to ask if there were any plans pre-injury to tweak Roman Reigns' moveset somewhere down the line to prevent the five moves of bullshit criticism that Cena gets.
It's like everybody's got a finisher and some semi-finishers. You know, like off the top of my head, Sheamus has the bro kick. That's his finisher. But he's also got the white noise, and he's got the fucking the pounding on the chest over the ropes.
Right.
They've got things they do in every match, but that like Roman Reigns can do a body slam, suplex, fucking armbar, whatever. He's got stuff. He just has the big boot to the face on the apron. Mm-hmm. He's got the Superman punch, the spear. He's got like three finishers, which is good because it helps you when you do false finishes in pay per views where you fuck the crowd, like tease them, like oh this is gonna be the finish. Oh, it's not. When you have more moves that you can hit, and people are like, oh, it's over, 1-2, you know what I mean? Right. It makes it more dramatic.
Right.
AJ Clark's his thoughts on a possible Orton-Lesnar feud if they turn Orton face. Ryan Clark's biggest fan from the chat room is AJ Clark.
Orton-Lesnar feud? Nah,
I don't think
not in the near, I mean,
maybe, you know what? Eventually, probably. And if they turn Orton face,
low on main eventers now, so.
If they turn Orton face, like he says, then absolutely.
Yeah. No doubt. Jason Anson, I know you guys don't watch NXT often, but the new breed of divas have been tearing the house down. Absolutely, man. Do you think Charlotte will be called up anytime soon? Her match with Natalya a few months ago was the best women's wrestling match I've seen in all my years of wrestling. It was...
I mean, Gail Kim and Taryn Terrell was crazy,
that was
too.
Pretty good. That was
Trish
good.
And Lita, back,
match
in the,
that they
Trish
had,
and Lita back in the day.
Yeah. Charlotte, you know, they just made Charlotte NXT Divas Champion, so...
Well, not just. It was at the second special.
Right. Yeah. Well, that was 3 weeks ago.
No, that was the third special 3 weeks ago. NXT TakeOver 2. She wanted to take over 1. She won it from Natalya.
Right, she's had it for a while.
She's had it for a couple months.
All right.
So they could call her up soon.
Charlotte
Paige was
the title?
Paige was the NXT champion when she was called up. They just had her give it back. Yeah, Charlotte won it from Natalya. Remember, Ric Flair and Bret Hart were in their corners, and Charlotte won, and Ric Flair cried, and all this and that. That's when she won the title.
Natalya didn't have the NXT.
It was vacant because Paige was the NXT champion, called up and gave it back. Yeah.
All right.
Don't you know that from now on, just if I'm saying something, agree with it.
I didn't disagree right there.
But you were confused. Like,
I was confused, and you clarified it for me.
But because I'm saying it,
I was confused, you clarified it for me, and I agreed.
But you shouldn't even need to wonder, because if I'm saying it, you should know, you know what? He's never wrong. This guy's never wrong. He's saying something. Yeah, you're right, Matt. And then later on, try and remember. Well, I don't know where we are right now. Which one?
Why?
Jason Hansen?
Well, what's the last one I just read?
I don't fucking know.
Right here, Vincent Nugent.
Vincent Nugent, clear your throat, bro. What are you doing?
I need a drink. I'm out of beer. I'm trying to get out of here. We're 15 minutes over.
We're 12 minutes over. Vincent Nugent says, do you guys think that latest serious injury, which is an incarcerated hernia... I thought he was trying to fix us from earlier, because I said incarcerated means
yes.
Going to jail. I was trying to make sure I didn't say it wrong, dickhead. Yeah, I think it is incarcerated hernia.
Oh,
yeah.
Roman
Reigns was kind of a blessing in disguise. If so, will WWE warrant to push
warrant
a different star?
What are you talking about?
I think he want to push a different star in the upper echelon of the card.
I think, dude, Roman's push, it's going to continue when he comes back.
While he's gone, they're going to have to push somebody else to the upper echelon to fill his void, looks like it's going to be Ambrose.
Thank God it's only 2 months that he's out, too.
Well, right? We don't know that.
Hopefully.
Several months is what they're saying.
Hopefully. It was 4 to 6 weeks, and now it's several months.
All right,
we
have been saying several months to the fans when he comes back, like,
it's
they
like
can
a
say,
surprise.
Like, he came back because he's such a badass. He came back sooner than we thought he was going to because he's so tough.
Yeah. You might be. You're probably right on
Could
that,
be.
To be honest with you. Dan Landgren, the slim
probably
chances.
Probably right. I'm always right.
Oh, he's this motherfucker. Dan Landgren, the slim chance of CM Punk shows up Monday, right?
Did he really say that? Let me read that. Dan Landgren says, the slim chance if Punk shows up Monday, Ryan, you must do the show with no hat. Gotta like your odds.
Man. Wow. Can we end the show after that? Even somebody...
Let me make sure there's nothing really good to ignore here. Hold on. Okay, nothing. Nothing.
The fact
we'll
that
end on that.
Somebody brought up that there's just a possibility that CM Punk may show up on Raw next Monday. I will look you directly in the camera. If
Look him directly in the camera and say, Did you hear the rumors? Did you hear the rumors? Go ahead and do your declaration. Yeah, if CM Punk shows up.
Did you hear the rumors?
There you go.
If CM Punk shows up on Monday Night Raw next Monday night, I will come on here next Tuesday night from 8 to 10 Eastern time without my hat.
No hat.
No hat. See you next Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern time. Full
feedback! Do you not want feedback?
Can I get some motherfucking feedback?
Yeah.
Is CM Punk going to be on Monday Night Raw?
Oh, God.
Next Monday night from Chi-Town, Chicago, Illinois. Is he going to be there? Is he not going to be there? Is Ryan Clark going to come on here
Did
next
you hear
Tuesday
the rumors?
Night?
Yeah.
Did you hear the rumors? Yeah.
Facebook.com/...
Did you hear the rumors? Ryan Clark may be here next Tuesday night. No hat.
Hatless.
If CM Punk
as
shows
rumored.
Up on Raw.
Yeah.
We want your feedback.
Facebook.com/RyanClarkWCR. Facebook.com/MattBoomWCR. Let us know what you like of the show. We'll do more of it. Let us know what you don't like. We'll do less of it. We try and make the show the way you want it. Apparently you guys thought we were soft in hour one. Let us know if we improved in hour two. I need to take a breath. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWCR. Facebook.com/MattBoomWCR. Get us out of here.
Four. Matt Boom.
That's me.
Ryan Clark.
That's him.
Say, see you next
Tuesday. Maybe without a hat next week.
Say, see you next Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern Time, WZROnline.com.